Welcome everyone to Not to the West, because boo, I don't run that game.
Hey.
I run a different one.
Don't boo my campaign.
I mean,
we love
yay!
My campaign.
Yay, we're not doing to the West. Welcome to the Scarlet Ball Session 2. We're doing a shorter one because we have lives outside of this game. And those lives are important to take care of. And so we're just gonna go till 9. So with that, I'm gonna start us off. So you all arrived in the little town of Tulit, and there you went to the...
Wait, how is Tulit spelled?
T-U-L-U-N.
Oh, Tulin. Okay, gotcha. I heard Tulit, and I'm like...
I heard Tulip. I was like,
what? All right,
that works really well with lore.
You went to Tulin and went to the Broken Bowl. You made a friend called Trevor, who took your weapons, turned out to be part of a gang, also ambushed you. You met a mysterious person on a radio, also met Melody Adderpool, who you'll meet at the mansion. You also left there after trying to figure out how to disguise as ornaments and joined Derby as he headed back into, well, head to the manor with his traveling shop. And you all got into the kind of main rooms of the manor, and all right, where was everyone? Real quick, going around this way.
I was just coming out into the my adoring fans to receive me.
He was coming out. Congrats,
oh,
me.
Oh my gosh!
Wow.
He is a chef. Anyway.
I was
what?
He's coming out as a chef.
Oh.
Yeah, anyway.
So I was sword shopping, but I discovered that he doesn't take checks, so.
Oh, yeah. And then, Levi, where were you? Oh, you were left at the drinking place with...
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Accurate.
And you had, last thing...
Grand
Knives had just told you some cryptic stuff, and...
Sleep of the Mariner looking for...
Anyway, and you had just taken drugs.
Yes.
Yeah. Anyway. So, Grand Knives just kind of, well, there, hope to see you around. I'm going to get back to my man. Come by and say hello whenever you like.
Oh, but yes, of course. And if you see your mariner friend again, just tell him to come say hello, will you?
Oh, I will. Bye-bye. She leaves and walks off.
I'm going to, like, storm across the area and find Adrian.
All right, you go across there. Oh, actually, you see Thomas. What is Thomas doing?
I was looking at swords last time.
Looking
I
at swords, he turned your way. So you just see her storming off, Percy storming off, and heading into the other room. Yeah, so you basically get to the other side, the kind of mirror room of this. and you see there's Adrian and the old man are both at the counter. Did you guys get any drinks or anything? Did you want to do that?
He did.
I did.
Yes.
And I'm like fake sipping it.
Okay. What did you get? Because there are drinks. I actually should bring up.
I think someone had recommended something, and that's what I got.
Yeah, I think.
I think Grand Knives recommended
Grand
something.
Knives.
Grand Knives would know the best.
What's your list?
For you
don't
specific.
Think he at least said it.
like Grand Knives.
She
gets
said
you drink
that you
for
should
you.
Try the Gristle.
So I'll get that or have that or something.
The weird statue thing makes it for you and hands it to you on like the little, it basically has like this like platter almost like attached to like the arms, and they have like little mechanisms like off of that, so it just kind of picks it up and like offers it to you.
I'm gonna like fake sip, but then taste just the slightest bit that's on my lip and see if I can tell if it's poisoned.
All right, roll a study check. Cleverly, I would say, and if you have a poison focus, you can do that.
One success.
Okay, you taste this, and you're like, okay. For a moment, you're like, wait, is that poison? And then you're like, no, that's just alcohol, which could be a kind of poison if I drink too much. But it seems to be fine. It's nothing like you could take this. There's not... and. You feel like it's a very heavily alcoholic, but there's also like, it feels pretty like sturdying. You feel kind of good after that taste. Yeah. So it seems like a normal drink.
She's trying to kill me.
Hmm.
I didn't say nothing.
Who is trying to kill you?
I'm Judy Garland.
At that point, Percy comes back, storms back to where you two are.
Adrian?
Yes?
Do you remember when you told me earlier that if I had any need for that sword that I gave back to you, that you'd use it for me?
Yes.
Well, I have a mission for you.
Of course.
I am not sure if this will happen, but if you happen to see someone walking around here in a diver suit, have you ever seen a diver suit before, Adrian?
Like a dumpster diver?
No, like an ocean diver.
They'll kill you.
Could I perform a check to see if I know what this is?
Yeah.
This is not that important.
I just. Yeah, roll a study. I would say void lore if you had any.
Dumpster,
if there's any, like,
sea-ish
things.
Yeah, I don't.
That.
I do have. I have history and I have swimming.
Check. Add history.
Okay.
Why do you have swimming?
This will be unknown difficulty, but the higher you get,
fair enough,
the better it'll be.
Oh, that's not too good, but wait, hold on. Cleverly?
Yeah.
Okay, let's see. 10, 5, 11, 10. That is just one success.
Just one success.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know what diver suits are like.
Okay.
Yeah, really? Like, I mean... At least, like, old-timey designs, you know, probably
yeah.
People have continued on. But actually, if Percy, do you explain kind of what that would be?
Sir Adrian, do you know how you wear a full-body set of armor all the time?
Of course.
Well, it's kind of like that,
yes.
Except it's more brass and it has a, not a visor, glass up front, so you can see through it a little bit better.
Interesting.
You probably, I feel like since, I don't know, maybe diving... equipment became better, or they phased out the idea of let's drop a person down.
Right.
You probably, because of history,
yeah,
like,
it's
yeah,
probably.
I've brushed across that.
Yeah.
I kind of know what that would
and
be.
Right.
Sometimes they have big, long harpoons that they throw at things.
Hmm.
That,
yes.
That's well, what they kill you
that
with.
You kind of are like, well, I don't know if they do that, because technically, if you're underwater and it, pressure reaches a point, that throwing stuff is not going to be a great idea.
But...
those are
I
things,
have a job
yes.
For you.
What is the job?
If you see someone walking around this bowl with a diver's suit on, like I described, don't kill them. But they might be a threat. So
the statue is just like lean forward.
I'm not talking to you.
It just moves back.
So, what I need you to do, Pet, is if you see a diver walking around here, to tail him as inconspicuously as you and all your glory can.
And all my what? What is my glory?
Your glory.
Oh. Well, I think.
Yeah, sure. Follow him. And then tell me what you see.
Very well. How exactly is this... undersea explorer a threat?
I don't know yet. I'm still piecing it together, you see.
Did you run into him?
No.
Both of you guys roll for... Actually, all three of you roll for perception, just really quick, to study the sound that makes sense.
Cleverly? Or carefully?
Carefully.
Nice.
Woo, not bad. Two successes.
Okay.
One success.
Swiftly, since I'm still in the middle of trying to piece it all together and doing it too fast.
Sure.
Yeah. Two successes.
Okay, you see Grand Knives is just coming up on
okay,
you.
Okay, now, don't say anything in front of her.
Okay, Grand Knives comes up. Hi, dear, how are you? Oh, you tried the crystal. How is it?
It's not poison.
Good. You notice something that you notice is your stomach feels odd and very kind of warm, as do your muscles. Put a little star next to your... survive track, and let me know when you get hit.
No.
Anyway. It's very good, actually. So where are you all from? Just then, someone comes up behind her and just like, excuse me. Just this young guy with like, he has like this like very blonde hair and has like almost like looking like white-ish for like streaks. Excuse me, you three, I was told to look out for some weird people. Did you come here with five, were there five of you originally?
Well, I resent the insinuation, but yes.
Yes!
Okay, cool. Yeah, so you're called over, I'm supposed to tell you some stuff. Just then another guy comes up behind and he's wearing like the servant mask. Is, older gentleman.
I'm Joe Hyde. We need you up just at the caller's table.
It's me. He lifts it up. It's the guy that you talked to who you paid to get in. I arranged it that you can talk to the, we couldn't find you in the guest book, but we're going to have you meet the leaders of the party, and they'll probably remember who you are. Is your grandson here?
Who?
Okay, come with me. You guys with him?
Well,
Grand's like, yes.
I'm going to just try and step by them and just say, I believe we have been summoned to something a little bit more important. Shall this matter wait?
No. He's coming. Got to do my job.
What is your name?
James.
James. James. We are here on this property for very serious business.
The other guy, it's oh man, the cold. It's so, it's so cold outside. Mm. Man.
We are here to protect the furnace of this fine establishment. It's so cold.
He's like just doing the kind of.
I know.
And the other guy's like, what is going on?
I was under the impression we were going to get to kill people.
What?
I've been poisoned.
How dare.
Oh yes, there is a fighting rink. Yeah, let's all, the guy with the wires. Yeah, let's all go. Let's just go meet the guest, the leader of the party. Yeah, let's do that.
Do you have any antidotes to poison?
The outer pools are waiting. Let's go. Everyone, come on.
I'm James.
Hello, James.
The guest, or the servant is a, are you guys?
Earlier, he said he was Perseverance Glemming. For reference, I'm Perseverance Fleming.
I never
He's
said
just
that.
Like that.
He just like lowers his mask back down and just like.
Very well.
Not enough for this.
Whoever you are, just come find us after you speak to the
I'm
host.
I'm Jadrian.
Okay. He just grabs your arm and starts leading you away, and Grangrin just follows. Ideas.
Goodbye.
Right, the other guy. Okay. Wait. What'd you say your last name was?
Fleming.
Oh, cool. That's my name, too. Are you from Gristle?
Yes.
Like, Lower Gristle?
No.
Like,
what do you take me as?
No? Okay. Never mind. Anyway. Hold on a second.
Are you all related?
No.
Well, you have to be.
Byron and Mariana Fleming.
No.
You have the same
you
last name, you're related.
Uncle Kirk?
No.
Okay, I guess it's just the name. Hold on a second as I find where I put my characters. And...
Everyone tried to steal my name today.
Oh, there we go. Anyway, I'm like Tibble... I'm Tibble Fleming.
Well, weird that you've got the same last name.
Yeah, it is. Anyway, you can just call me Tibble. So I am the butler for Melody Adderpool, and she told me to come find you guys when you came in. Sorry I had something to do when you were called, yeah, or when you made your announcement.
Insight check on this chap.
All right, insight check.
Am I over getting checked out with the guest book?
Hmm?
Is that what's happening?
Basically, the servant said that you had been checked out, or they had checked this guest book. They couldn't find you, so they're taking you to the head. People.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, nothing.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, you know, you're not on your game today. You're not sure what he's doing.
What on earth were you doing that kept you from us for so long?
Why are we keeping these things secret from the hired staff?
Well,
because people at a party don't want to know that things are going to get stabbed soon.
Right, but the staff. Also, you were the one, if I do recall, that commented on your innate desire to kill people.
Well, listen, just because they don't want other people to know doesn't mean that I do.
Okay. Indeed.
Did Melody... She didn't consult anyone, did she, when she hired you guys?
I believe that's why we're here. We are the consultants. Right.
Anyway,
what a daft title.
Yeah. You guys?
Yes.
Anyway. All right, the reason why we don't want anyone to know about it is
Wait! Where's the rest of our group? Do you want to talk to us with everyone here?
Yeah, that'd be good.
You know, okay. The man you just sent off was one of us.
Yes.
And I think the chef might still be down in the kitchen.
Oh, okay. All right, then we'll try and find him first.
Ask
and
for Butcher.
Butcher?
Let's go find the nobleman.
Thomas.
Okay. Yes, that was his name. Thomas!
All right, so you guys go off to, like, look there. Thomas, are you doing anything in the other room?
Was the sword sale next to, like, the fighting ring?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm just kind of, like, over there checking out what's going on, kind of just milling around.
You just see that people are setting stuff up. They're, like, getting these, like, whale oil canisters, and they're just putting by, like, a little generator that's going to, like,
whale oil.
Turn on
stuff.
Around it. And, like, this one guy's like, now remember, keep the generation really low because we don't want anyone to get light-gated when they walk into it, okay? Cool. We just want them to get, like, possibly paralyzed. That's it. We're playing by gentlemen's rules in this match. Anyway.
Did you say gentlemen's rules?
You
am I here?
Yeah.
So you guys,
I heard the phrase
you
gentleman.
Come out and you're trying to look for where the people are, and they actually see you coming around, and Tipple Fleming is like, he just walks over to where you're at.
He's waving at everybody that waves at him. He's out there to celebrate his achievement with his food.
He comes up to him. Are you Butcher?
Aye.
Okay, cool. You're coming with us.
Says who?
Melody. I'm sent to get you guys.
Aye, I can do that.
Okay, cool. Alright, that's okay. We just need one more. They go into the next room. You have been taken by the arm, I guess, or whatever. The guys led you over to the main room. At the top is this big table, and on it are a bunch of different people. You see a man and a woman who are sitting together. There's an older gentleman with a big mustache, and then there's a girl next to him with black hair. And there's, like, a very, like, grumpy-looking man who's sitting, like, next to her, who is, like... He was like discussing something with the man with the mustache, and then he just kind of like leaves and like leaves there. And you notice that he has this like his left arm is actually gone, and there's a robotic one in its place. And he leaves. And you get to the table in this room. The Adderpools, Warden, Mr. Adderpool. This is.
I'm just a Grima Vera.
This is. Gostream Magera and
Just Agreemavera.
Just Agreemavera.
I never said that.
This is someone we are not. We don't have. We didn't have a ticket for him, and so we're going to check the booking. So I'm just wondering if you recognize him, Mr. Powerful, the man with mustache.
What's your name, good sir?
I'm Jinglehammer.
Jinglehammer. I don't think I know anyone by that name.
I don't either.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. Daughter!
The girl is like, who's talking to the young man, and the girl is just kind of like, oh, yes, Dad.
did you, what was your name again?
Joseph Kasuntai.
Yeah, you know Joseph Kasuntai.
No, she just goes back, keeps talking to
Melody, do you know what Joseph is inside?
She looks at you.
Oh, yeah, I remember Joseph. Hi, Joseph.
My name is Monk.
Yes.
Strong.
yes, he's on the guest list. I added him. I gave him one of the tickets.
Okay, it's a rose. It's fine, sir. You can go. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Apple. No, that's fine. You. Millie.
No, actually, I'm going to talk with him real quick.
It's almost as like energetic as Maxim Kenrick.
Anyway, so Melody comes around. She's wearing this like white, kind of frilly, not really frilly, but like where it's like silk, but it's like a bunch of different layers. And so it just looks very like, it looks like just a white dress, but you look in, there's a bunch of details and stuff. And she's like smiling. And she's like, okay, where's the rest of your group?
You know who was on the radio earlier?
That was me.
The one after and before you.
Oh, was there someone else on me?
Mm-hmm.
That's weird.
They're trying to kill me.
They're trying to kill you?
Yeah.
That's not good.
Probably all of us.
Do you know where your friends are?
No.
Okay, well, we're going to find them. Now. And just then you guys come in, and they look, and she's like, she waves the tables. And like, so they meet. She actually points off over there. And, like, and so they like head off into the other room. As this group goes in, you guys also see Thomas and Tybalt.
As we're are we fetching Thomas?
As just like the whole group is just moving into the other room where the fighting rink is. Yeah. So we're in there. Grand is just walking behind you guys, just kind of like okay. But then she like sees it and she like that you guys are kind of doing this group thing and she just like pats your hand and just,
I'll be back. See you when you're done with whatever. Your little powwow.
Right. She leaves.
Percy will jog a couple of steps, just very subtly, to get up in front of the group. And she would kind of sneak up a little bit, and then Thomas would just see her standing uncomfortably close, and she would say, "Did you know, Thomas, whales have the biggest brains of any creature on the earth. Do you know what him lies the smallest?"
I swear if you say me, I'm going to just
throw you in the ring. Oh, you heard this one already.
Throw you in
the ring. Everyone else is back there. And she's going to, like, wheel her
around. Are we all here for this?
You guys are coming up behind it, so.
The butcher would see the fighting rink and just crack his knuckles and cross his arms.
You've been having fun. Right.
Aye.
Tybalt just looks very concerned at all of you.
Listen, everyone, we are here on business. What's the business?
Did you ever find the bar?
Yes.
It's right over there.
There's also drugs.
There's poison in the air.
Yeah, it's all poison, I say.
Of course. Legalized poison.
We should continue on our quest uninhibited.
All right. The two people. Okay, guys, come up this way. And so you go. This is the other side. So you go up this passageway. And as you walk through, there's like pictures and stuff. And there's actually a few like armored suits that you see. They are. Next to them are replica. It's just a little like that's a replica made by so and so, and there's this whole like bio of who it made the replica, but it's just like just some guy, and it's like not very.
Are any of these suits of armor inhabited and trying to kill me?
Roll a paranoid check.
Can I evaluate how well they are made?
Yes, you can do that. You can add your history to that.
Okay.
I definitely
maybe
got one
fighting
success.
If you want, if that's better than steady.
Would I be able to
want.
Add any sort of
it is actually
focus to this?
That is just
what? Would I be able to add any focus to this?
Do you have anything that you could call for paranoid?
No,
then you can't do that.
Could I ask what the difficulty is?
Got one success.
Probably not very high. Probably one.
Okay, yeah, I got two.
Okay. Even two, yes, average. Or two, take a. Take
yay!
That.
Okay.
So you take that. And, so you see these, they are pretty standard, they're pretty badly made. Like, they're good replicas, but you can tell that the metal they're made from is just, like, maybe it was painted, maybe it was just a really thin wood, or, like, a really thin, not wood, a really thin metal. Like, this would just,
weird,
like, you could probably, if you hit it really hard, it just bend.
Aluminum or something?
Yeah, it was something like that.
Success.
You got one success. You can't see anything in the eye slits, so there's probably nothing in there unless it's a very short.
We gotta do a Scooby Doo chase.
You guys enter into
tapping on the armors.
You guys enter into this library. It's just kind of around. There's like different little places. There's an upstairs place too. There's a big globe in the center of the room. There's this like this place where there's a bunch of books, and there's just like this little like thing that you spin, and there's like book signs. So it just kind of goes down. This, you all get in there. There's some people, and they're just kind of leaving, going out the back way, and then you just like, okay. Melody's like, okay, everyone. She goes over to a bookshelf, pulls off like an encyclopedia, and she puts it down on the floor, and she gets on it. She's like, okay, everyone. My name's Melody. Nice to meet you all.
Hi, so, Melody.
Hi. It's good to see you again, Butcher. How have you been? And Tibble's like, oh, yeah. So, basically, you're all here because there's been rumors about something going down tonight. My family is not necessarily loved in this town, and they don't...
Someone already poisoned me.
What? No, I've been watching him. I think it's fine.
It's in the drinks.
Okay. Good to know. Maybe I won't drink. Anyway, so basically, I'm going to give you... I've hired you to basically be a defense force and also a bit of a detective force. I want you to just patrol the house, make sure everything's good. If you can find out anything of what could be happening... There's not many of the guests knew about like when we were going to do the Scarlet Ball, so I think a lot of them are off the table, but there are quite a few people who are pretty intimately knowledge that knew about it. If you need any questions or anything, let me know. If there's anything in the house that would be useful, just feel free to take it. Don't worry about that. I'll be around if you need any help, but I have to do festivities. You guys have met Tibble. Very nice. There's also my sister's butler. I told her that if you need anything, he can also help you. But yeah.
So we can go wherever we want to.
Yes, you can.
And we can tell everybody that you told us that.
Yes. They might not believe you, though. So you might need me sometimes.
Or okay.
Just, yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
What do you know about the fish heads?
The fish heads are the local big gang. I think they've been getting more powerful. It's kind of all that they've been kind of absorbing different groups and stuff.
They tried to kill us. They tried to kill us.
They did a very bad job of it, too.
I knew it was going to happen.
Sent three people and none of them were even halfway competent.
When did this happen?
Oh, earlier, back in the tavern.
Before we had the radio conversation.
Oh, that was going on outside while I was inside.
And the other guy who tried to...
I chopped off
one guy.
Kill
us. Do you still have it?
No, I gave it back to him.
The leader spoke to us via radio transmission.
Peasant.
Oh, that's what he was talking about. Mm. Yes. Do you know what he said? Is he behind it? Or?
Well, he suddenly seemed to be claiming it, that nefarious blackguard. But he could be bluster. He spoke a lot about blood, which was a little disconcerting.
I think he wants to cause trouble here.
Hmm.
Okay, maybe that's what's going on.
Sounds like it.
But yeah.
The ones that talk too much never do too well, so I wouldn't be too worried.
Okay, that's good. Yes, so if you need anything, feel free to... Yeah, feel free to take... is there anything else? Oh, if you see Osiris, he's been feeling a little lonely, so if you can pet him for me, that would also be really good.
What's Osiris?
Tibble's like, it's the cat.
What's a cat look like?
He's orange.
Oh, I do enjoy cats. I had
a cat try to kill me.
I had a cat named...
back in prison, we learned how to make a nice,
tuna.
Nice burger.
Do not cook Osiris.
Don't touch the cat, you dirty person.
If he does, I will consider him a threat to this party.
Whales. Don't insult Tuna Fish. She was my childhood cat.
Your cat's name was Tuna Fish.
Yes, I was like three when I got her a birthday present. Of course I'm going to pick a stupid name. I was three.
See? Smallest bird of any animal around.
Won't you, cat?
That is wrong. There are numerous rats and even smaller creatures that have brains.
Have you looked inside his head?
I believe that given Thomas is capable of speech, that his brain is not that small.
You should check.
Ooh, and
also
your biggest concern for making sure that
back
you protect
off.
Me and the rest of my family, and also the guests, that the guests do not come to harm either.
Mm.
What about the guests that are trying to kill us?
That's fine. You can assume that they're not good guests. protect good guests, not bad guests. Mm. Also, no, we're watering guests outside, so probably don't leave outside.
Wait, what is going on outside?
We're watering the garden, so probably just stay inside the house.
Mm.
But what if they
wet
run outside when then we're chasing?
Probably
them
go after them.
Even though you're watering?
It's fine. Okay. I mean, just, like, it's not dangerous, it's just kind of annoying. They're not great at watering. They're a bit of jerks. Anyway.
Do you need a bodyguard? An escort?
I don't think so. We have a lot of guards around.
What if they're trying to kill you?
Hmm.
So have you guys
in on it?
But we're not guarding you.
But I think
they're close.
We are.
They could kill you before we even
we're
got
there. We're
supposed
to figure it out before they get the opportunity.
Well, they're going to.
Tibble's like, I'll make sure she's safe. Like, don't worry about it.
You're in on it.
Good.
Probably.
Is there a good place to watch over the entire party? If we could have one person standing lookout, it would be very supportive of our own defenses.
Not really. It's kind of the main three rooms.
Mm.
And then there's some back rooms and places too. Mm. So I don't think there's really mainly. People are going to mostly be on the first floor. I think the upper floor is pretty much off limits. So that's helpful.
Mm.
Anyway, gets off the book, puts it back on there.
You're not even going to dust it off first.
Ew, it's
tickled.
It's just an encyclopedia.
He just walks over and just dusts, like, takes out a duster and just, like, dusts both sides and puts it in.
Okay.
She's like, okay. She's like, this little, like, salute with, like, her cane and just leaves. Good luck, guys. And just tibble. Yeah, so do you guys need any clarifications or can I just leave?
You can go.
Okay, cool. Just then the lights, like, flicker and, like, there's like this like sound outside of like a almost like a electrical popping noise. And Dibble's like, ugh.
That's quite different,
like,
huh?
Yeah, that's been happening. We have a electric gate or electric fence around it, and it's been going on and off.
I bet
lot
it's the guy on the radio.
So
that's
if you want to check that out, that might be a good place to start.
Very
suspicious. But it's kind
we
of
might
nice
as well.
You remember the guy talking
there's some
to
generators.
Us.
Oh, him.
Let's see.
He's in the fence.
Where?
He's in the fence.
There's a few generators.
Probably.
Oh, there's actually one
sure
over here, and there's one in the other room, too. Kind of opposite to this. So, you'll kind of explain this if there's a
room
here, and then there's also the one right here, and the Vista generator at these locations. So he just points to you and it's like, there's like a hidden latch that you can open up.
Well, Adrian, why don't we go check out that one while they get this one?
Very well, but first, do you have lanterns?
Yes.
I think they might be trying to target the power. And if light is out, we need some sort of beacon to light our way.
Or you could just see in the dark.
I cannot do that, can you?
Yeah.
Really?
No.
Oh.
I'll go get lanterns.
Good man.
Okay.
Yes.
He just leaves.
I have a question for you.
Yes.
He looks
what
very
is
concerned.
What knights are supposed to do?
What do you mean?
I mean, you're a knight, right?
Well, I suppose so. I'm more of a peruser of antiquities and bodyguard and mercenary.
But what does a knight do?
Well, it depends on your historical or romantic definition.
Give me the romantic one.
Well, knights always do good, never do wrong, and do good for the good people, and bad for the bad. Wait, no. Do bad things to the bad people.
I track with that.
Yes.
They also do favors for ladies, don't they?
Typically, yes.
Well, I have a thing you
and
can
men
do. Do you want to do with
sometimes
me?
Sometimes. What's that?
I have a thing that I need you to do.
What is the thing?
There are female knights! That's what I was going for. Dishonored is an egalitarian society, man.
I am looking
yes
for an amethyst.
Yes.
It would just complement the outfit very well.
I'm not stealing
this
it.
You don't
yes
need
to. Yes, you are right here.
Okay.
If you find particularly remarkable amethyst. Just send the owner to me and I'll buy it off of them.
Very well. You did, in fact, give me my sword back, so I will assist you in your endeavor to find an amethyst.
Yes, find a good amethyst. And if you see a diver, tell me.
Amethyst and diver.
Yes.
You do have a strange and varied amount of interests, lady. Wait, shoot.
He has the same name.
Fleming, that's it, yeah. Oh, yes. You're related to James.
No, I'm not.
You are?
No.
You bear the same last name.
That's Tybalt, no.
I'm James Fleming.
I'm talking about James. Yes, that one. Well, not that. The one he's.
You're not my son.
I'm a woman.
That explains
it. And what is your last name, good sir?
No, wait, that's a town in Wales.
What's Wales? Oh, no, I know.
What are Wales? Who are you?
You said it like a place. Is there a place where they're just whales?
No, it's called the ocean.
Well, I know, but it's not called Wales.
It's called my father's oil barrels.
No, it's not there either.
Hey, Thomas.
Generators! Generators of power and electricity. Adrian. The beacons of light. Yes!
You know another fact about whales?
Do tell me, dear Perseverance.
Whales don't care for this conversation. Let's go.
Did you know that whales spend their
he goes
size
and
whoa, I do.
To basically the size of their own bodies.
Wait, what?
Butcher.
Do you let me out to anything she actually said real quick?
All right, this is your last whale fact of the day.
Thomas, whales have throats that can expand the size of their entire bodies. And they can have up to 13 stomachs. Did you know that?
Okay.
Which, if you're thinking about this in terms of application...
What? Are you saying I have 13 stomachs?
I'm sorry again.
If you think of this in terms of application, what are the applications of whales 13 stomachs to tell?
Your application point for today.
Think about this in terms of application. Whales haven't fought back yet, but if they did, you'd get eaten and you'd stay there for hundreds of years.
Not if I'm on land, darling. Not if I'm on land.
Whales can travel through the void. I'm pretty sure they can get on land if they wanted to.
Suddenly the old man's like right next to him. He's like,
"Yeah, you two can take void points." Oh, everyone gets void points, and then you two can take extra. Just because that was chaotic.
I don't have a pencil, so I can't write any messages. Wait, how many points do I get?
So one for just the
can I inside check you?
It's the next session.
It's not going to do anything, but
okay, so
one extra.
So I'm doing an inside check on something that the old man said.
All right, roll against the jeweler.
That is no successes.
Well, I got three.
Okay,
so.
All right.
Oh, you cannot read the old man. He gazes into the middle distance.
Thank you.
Well, digestive tracts of aquatic mammals aside.
It might become relevant in its future.
I do not believe that whales...
alcohol for this.
I don't think whales are real.
Thomas takes a hearty swig out of his flask.
I don't think you're real. I believe you are just an hallucination.
Yes.
What is your name, Jemima Puddle Duck?
Jarvis.
Jarvis.
Jarvis Bersmaddleback.
Bersmaddleback to you.
Oh, fair enough.
What is your name?
Just then an orange cat leaps up on like it's wall, and it just looks at you.
Grabby.
Thomas
like,
too.
Sorry, that wasn't very gentle.
He looks just like tuna fish.
What if I try more gentle? Is that okay?
Butcher.
And I'm gonna like pet the cat.
Stay back.
Thomas is also like cat. Cat.
Void point. And if you're already filled, then you can add a new one.
Yes.
Wait, what? What does the cat do?
She just got void point.
Yes.
Whoa, man.
The Thomas butcher is going to hold his hands out because he just was just in the kitchen, so his hands
it
were in
it just bites
the
your finger and starts chewing on it.
He's just sitting there.
I'm going to, like, he's gonna lean down and stare into the cat.
And then when you try and pay, it just, like, pulls back. And just,
you know, I had a cat named Tuna Fish when I was, like, three.
You told us, like, four times.
I know. Nobody's reacting to the fact that I had a cat. like this one.
You're not interesting.
Cats are cute.
Yes, but yours isn't here. It's dead.
How dare! There is no insult of honor that is worse than insulting a person's pet.
He kills whales.
You do not stoop that low.
The cat's trying to kill us.
Did he kill your pet whale?
I don't have a pet whale, but someday. Someday.
Tuna fish.
You can't have a pet whale.
Leave pets out of the insultery.
You're right, you're right. I'm sorry. To you, not you.
Good day, Osiris.
You're very good.
Indeed.
He just kind of seems to nod at you.
I do believe this cat might possibly
be I respect this cat. Our own feline friend.
It also looks very like, you know that look of like, this is a well-kept cat, but the cat doesn't keep himself well, and so it just looks like kind of mangy. That mangy look of, you just were given the bad genes of not really like having your fur all like fit together well. Mm. And so he just always looks kind of ruffled.
Let's try this again. I'm joking, Mongo.
Joking.
Cat doesn't want
him. Mr. Grew.
I never said that.
I didn't think so. Let's start heading off the generator.
All right. Yes, towards the generator. Who is covering the other generator?
That's my name.
Generator. What is your last name, Generator? Generator?
I'm not a generator.
Well, you generate something.
Confusion.
Yes, that.
Wait, so who goes to which place?
I'll take these two.
Smart.
Yes, the whale enthusiast.
Aren't you both whale enthusiasts? Just enthusiastic about different items involving whales.
Percy wasn't already halfway to the door right now.
Oh. Actually, my good sir, you do have a point.
Mm.
Okay, so to clarify, there's a generator in the library place, and then there's one in the other room, which is a gallery.
We're going towards the other room.
Okay.
The gallery.
So you two go to the other room. Does anyone else go? Okay, you guys are all staying here.
We're
so,
going to the other generator.
Oh, so everyone's all going to the other
room. We're splitting up.
Okay.
We're going to the other generator. They're going to the closed generator.
Yes.
Okay, closed generator is in this room. So you just go over to where that is. You guys both walk off. You guys go over to there. There's a, you just kind of look at where you'd point, and there's a lever just like next to just shelves that kind of like, not like the shelves that like, they like have like a curve to them, and so there's kind of more space, and then there's like a little break, and there's like another curve to them. That's kind of how it's set up, and then there's just a lever that's just kind of there that's like kind of.
I wasn't paying attention. What were we doing here?
Honestly, I don't remember, but there was a cat.
He's just gonna reach out and pull the lever.
Okay. You pull it just kind of like pulls back, and like there's just metal paneling, and you look inside, and there is a big generator just there with a bunch of oil cans, and then behind it are just like piles of like really big oil can. Like these are like oil cans that are for it, and it looks like the thing takes like a good number of these oil cans to like continue generating electricity, but there's just a ton more that are just all packed in behind it, and there's just like, yeah, that's basically what you see. And it's just kind of crackling, and there's like wires that go up into the ceiling and then go out.
Didn't Martin friend say something about turning off the power?
That's what the man in the radio said.
I
did.
So the electric fences are not the electric fences aren't working properly.
We need to turn them
the
off.
The radio man
fix them.
I'm not
you
sure.
You also
notice
that there's like a little radio
like,
with like several buttons
you know,
on there next
so
to you,
like
or like on like the wall.
I'm gonna like tap the radio.
Hey, are you on the fence?
You like get a little static.
He's not talking.
What buttons are there? What can I see?
There are like five buttons. They all look black. And they have
do
like
I
numbers
know what they,
on them.
Can I do a check to see if I know what they do? Can guess what they do?
Yeah, sure. Do a check.
Two successes.
Tinker something. All right, that would say, yeah, take one momentum. Yeah, so these are like, It's like which place you want to call. So probably like five other locations that have like these things. And so this is like if you were talking to someone, you could like call on and talk to someone else on the other end.
There's no controls for the generator though.
Oh, the generator. Yeah. If you want to, you can roll for that. But yeah, there looks like there are some like controls around for it. They're like on one of these like panels that are like around there. Looks pretty complicated. That's probably going to be a 3.
Okay.
I'm going to like press some of the buttons.
Oh, I got 2.
Okay. Just start doing that.
I got 2.
Yeah, so that's not enough. So you take a look at it and you're like, okay, all right, that's a lever, that's another lever, that's a monitor, that's okay, I have no idea what this is.
He's
like,
going
there's
to...
just, everything has, there's just a ton of stuff and you're like, I don't know what.
Is there a red button anywhere?
There's a lot of red buttons.
He's going, what's the biggest red button?
The biggest red button is over in a corner. Under it says, do not push.
He's going to push it.
Okay.
He's gonna first. He's gonna look. He's gonna stare at the writing very closely, and then
is this a noticeable thing?
He's
yeah,
going to
probably.
Push.
I should probably.
You guys both.
What the?
I'm gonna like sneak.
And
out.
Just as you're clicking the buttons, you would just notice before like you know it's just like different. Sometimes you click on one and like there's like noise, just like people in the background talking and stuff like that. But it sounds like. Maybe inside of like a restaurant or something like that sort of ambient sound or like something like that. So you're like, okay, I don't think there's anyone like on the other end. And then you look over and you see what's going on.
I'm gonna sneak out the room as soon as I see him leaning over and looking at the
okay.
This big red button.
Right, roll for that. And
you
guys
want to
see that and you can roll against them.
2 successes.
I
think. Wait,
also
that's
have.
Oh, never mind. That's
successes.
1 success.
One success, 2 successes. Thomas, are you trying to see what's going on?
Yes, also trying to see what's going on.
Okay, then you can roll for...
1 success?
Oh, do you have perception? No, you got... Yeah, that's 1.
I get 1 success.
1. So you guys don't notice. Old man just sneaks out. Osiris is just, like, looking at you. On top of the bookshelves. They're, like, just kind of... It's, like, in the middle of the room, there's just bookshelves. And he's just looking at you.
Does Osiris have ill intent?
Whole paranoid check. Yeah.
1 success.
Okay. He's a cat.
No.
He's not too... He's just a cat sitting there. He looks kind of bored. He's just watching you guys.
You just want to watch the world burn?
Yeah. Anyway, so you click the red button.
Does it make any noise or anything?
It makes a clicking noise.
Water.
And then just lights start flying. Please continue to hold.
What
for,
did you do?
Like for the shutdown process to continue. Are you gonna
I think
let
that's
go
what we're here for.
Why did you push that button?
All right.
Why would you push that button?
The door doesn't start closing on us at all or anything,
no.
Does it?
I hope it does when it actually shuts off. That'd be hilarious.
A voice comes over,
like, at
like
least the 3 of us are
like, on it. It's like, the shutdown process has begun. In 10, it's like, continue to hold for 10 seconds for the shutdown process to complete. It's like, 9, 8, 7,
our friend
6,
in the tin can said to turn it
5,
off.
We advise this process
okay.
will be hard to like make sure that this process. I don't know. She says, make sure that the process that you are you sure that you would like. If you are sure that you would like to continue the process, please press the blue button on the other panel, and it is all the way over there.
I'm going to stretch. It's
you are not quite far enough to.
Go push that one.
Why would I do that? What if it blows up the whole bloody place?
What Egypt would put a button to blow up the engine?
A lot of Egypts, actually.
Do it.
Alright, alright.
You have pressed now the blue button. Thank you so much for doing that.
You're
thank
welcome.
You for your patience. Now we will continue down the timer. 5, 4, 3. Now please hit the green
oh,
button
word,
to continue. There's a green one that's like on your panel. Like please hit the green one to continue.
Can I reach it?
Yes.
Okay.
You have to like reach quite a bit, but you can. Two, please hit the blue yellow button on the other panel, and you notice that there's a big blue audience. One, we are now going to shut down the process. Please wait and hold for 15 seconds. 15.
My fingers 14, hurt.
13.
I 12, hold it.
10. 9,
back on the high seas, you had to 8, hold ropes way 7, beyond when your fingers 6, would give out.
5.
See, I grew up 4, in a mansion.
3.
I grew up, you pansy.
2. 1. Thank you so much. We are now going to shut down this generator. Please go to the other generator to complete the process. And the lights just like flicker. And then like these like a few of the lights come on around you and then just you also hear the outside just like just a
so is it dark.
Yeah, it's there's like a few little lights come on. So and like you're like outside, just like in the like where there's like people like what's going on?
So what? It's like in the cartoons where it's like black and then just the eyes like.
Yeah. And then little lights start coming on around.
They
you.
Turned off their generator.
Right. You missed the
little
whole
lights turn
sequence.
On. And then you hear over the static. Wow, that was. I mean, I was gonna turn it off, but like I guess that works too. Sure. Yeah. So that was interesting, but I'll take it.
Was that just in the room that I'm no longer
oh, you're leaving, and you probably hear that voice.
Is that on the radio?
Yeah, it's on the radio.
Ah, mission accomplished. We did it.
I'm trying to shake your hand. You never shook someone's hand before.
Oh, his hands are still kind of bloody from making the meatballs actually, earlier, but he grabs his hand.
It's just, it's all over you. Yeah.
Sneak over to where the other generator would be.
All right. With you guys are going over. There's a little, like, hallway goes to the right. You kind of go around it. There's like actually two ways, but there's a guy standing. He just kind of looks at you and like, looks back. It's like one of the guards, and you just like, okay, not that way. We go around. You walk by. There's like a few notable lambs, which you're kind of just hurrying, and you get over into the gallery and you go in there. So the gallery is there's this main room right here, and then there's this kind of display place that kind of has little display windows all around it. There's like a little thing. You see, there's like a little door there with some locks on it. Over here, you actually see Grand. She's standing with some other people, and they're just kind of talking. There's like a few other just guests walking about. The other generator is on a secret panel back here. As you're walking over there, there's a part where just the lights like flicker again, and you hear like out in the main room, just like people are like discussions going on.
Hmm. We have to check that generator in quick. I'll go distract the people. You can check on it.
You are very distracting. Go ahead, Doc.
Yes, indeed. So what is the... I'm confused about the display area. Like, what is that?
So this area is like a little walkway. And then there's like paintings on the outside. There's like something over here. There's basically like little display windows.
Okay.
That have like items inside. So like... Kind of like a museum, basically, where there's like a little display case.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah. And there are items in there.
I'll be a distraction. Gets distracted.
Right. So, what are you doing?
I'm just going to go up to those three people, including Grand Knives, just to enter into their conversation.
Okay. You walk over, and there's Grand Knives, the lady, and the one girl with the red hair. And they're all just kind of talking. And Grand's like, yes, and so this is obviously fake. Like, these are just... They're just putting here to like look impressive, but like
it's one of those like the amethyst.
Yes, and you see twinkling the amethyst in the hairpin of the lady. She's talking. Which is disgusting. The red hair one's like, yeah, it's kind of weird. Like didn't people like we used to really hate the void, and now it's like in Grand's. Yeah, it's kind of better than it used to be. They were really about. Get on the backs of people who did the void and stuff and things like that. So, I'm much more enjoying it. Oh, hello.
Hello. Pardon me for...
Adrian?
Yes, that is my name that yes. I go by.
Let me introduce... These are my friends. This is Anne.
Good to meet you.
This is Amethyst.
This is Andy. Points to the red hair girl, also known as Adjury. If you're trying to Andy. And then this is Lady Lyra.
Andy, good to meet you. Lady Lyra.
Hello. Lyra just kind of nods at you. She looks very like, doesn't really want to talk to you.
Could I ask if you all were discussing any one of these various antiquities here?
Oh, yes. She points at a display case, which has, there's some whale bones and runes. Specifically these runes. If you look at it, it's actually a little too close in, so the design is off. Also, yeah, you can just kind of tell if you know, you've been around them long enough.
Mm-hmm.
But yes.
I have to be honest, I'm a little disappointed with the collection here. It seems all they have is replicas and nothing truly good.
Yes. The human-made heart is actually pretty cool, but again, replicas.
The what?
Oh, maybe you should take another look at the collection.
Would you mind showing me where that is?
Yes, let us come. So she leads you over.
Is everyone coming with us?
They are. They're going. They're all
okay,
going.
Okay, good.
Yes. Distraction.
And they lead you over. It's actually by like a doorway. Mm-hmm. So like there's another hall that goes back, and that leads back to the main hallway, or the main room on that side, the liquor lounge. I don't know, with the punch bowl. And so the generator is still like within sight that they can see it, but she points and like right here, and there is.
I want to stand in a position that kind of obscures her vision. I am pretty tall, and I am in a giant suit of armor, so I'd like
to.
This is
true, but. Hallway, it's basically a hallway, and it's kind of right there, so they're probably still going to, like, hear and see it, and they're just kind of there. And also, like, the lady doesn't really seem like she's, like, looking at this a lot.
Okay.
Andy is kind of like, okay, sure, we'll look at this. But he's just kind of looking around and stuff like that. But basically she points, and she's like, ah, it's right here. And there's a little display, and on one side is a replica of a heart that has, like, these like robotic parts added to it.
Yeah.
It's a replica, and like below it is, this is a replica of a heart that was in the academic, or the Academy of Natural Philosophy. It was a replica. Not a whole lot is known about it, but it seemed like it had some connection to Corvo Tano and when he went on his reign. Some people suspect that he went mad and was—
Some people are wrong.
And then right next to the left of it is an actual heart that has had the same operation put on. And so this one, and you see like it's not on, like there's no power to it or anything like that. So it's just a heart that's there. So this one is a attempted replica, like is an actual replica designed by some guy. It's like two. Show what this heart replica would have actually looked like. It is taken from the heart of a sailor that was lost at sea. Or not lost at sea, but died at sea. And that's
Mariner.
The sea.
Very macabre. Interesting. Well, that is quite unique. Not my particular...
Have you seen the suits of armor?
Oh, the one by the library?
No, those are, yeah. I mean, there's ones like over there.
No, I haven't. Would you all mind showing me?
Oh, sure. Lady's just like, do you want to show him? I mean, I thought we could all show him. Lady's like, no.
Excuse me, I insist. I have various mini tales that I can tell about suits of armor. It's my area of expertise, as you can tell. Tink, tink.
Yes, I could tell that.
Good.
I'm not particularly, no offense, but I'm not particularly interested in armaments.
Well then what are you interested, Lady Lyra?
My husband is an inventor, so I find his inventions fascinating.
Well perhaps you need to see suits of armor in the lens of that. Something that an inventor has crafted, put their heart into.
He looks around at the couple of hearts.
And he's just, ha! See what you did there.
Not literally. That would be weird.
would it be?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes. Definitely.
No.
roll persuasion check.
Technically, okay. You put your heart in a breastplate all the time. It's just still surrounded by other things.
Yeah.
You just have a bunch of squishy boy. Book also Talk protecting it.
Probably cleverly if you it's have like...
Could I do boldly?
Yeah, you could do that.
Okay, all right. One success.
Yeah, she had a critical success.
Ah,
so
darn.
She just... perhaps not.
Hmm.
I'll go and, I don't know, I'll catch up on my husband, see if he's doing anything. You two want to do that.
She needs to find interests outside of her husband. She needs to become more than the patriarchy
so
has
she leaves, and she goes the way,
you're like a serial
basically goes towards where you had went, and so she's walking that way. The other two, they start walking around this way, around.
Mm-hmm.
Towards, oh my
perfect.
So are you following them?
Yes.
So you go to there, yeah, and they're two cases and there's two suits of armor.
Mm.
Very similar to yours, you know, different era kind of stuff. There's like some differences and stuff that you can see. So Grand asked like a little bit to you like about what's kind of different.
Yeah,
you
yeah.
Know, so I think as an expert about it.
Mm-hmm.
You can roll for that.
So. Okay. Let's see.
You can't take tenants.
Yeah, three successes.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, take a success, or take a momentum.
Okay.
Yeah, so you tell them just about the armor, what era they came in, stuff like that. Grand looks pretty pleased, as does Addie. She seems pretty impressed.
And these are originals, not replicas.
These are originals. Mm-hmm. These are actually.
Very nice.
And you can tell it, like, you know, there's probably different pieces have been collected from different places and stuff like that. It's hard to get a full set of basically anything. That's an achievement
right.
in and of itself.
Absolutely.
Percy, you see that the people have left, but the lady is coming towards you. Roll seeing real quick.
There wasn't a moment where she was away where I could have slipped in?
Or would I be close
she's
enough?
She's walking towards like where you're going to be, and she's going to go past you, basically.
Would
so
I be close
well,
enough
soon
to
as
persuade?
Adrian had led them away, I would have slipped in.
Okay, roll for seeing, basically.
Am I...
Yeah, you probably come up behind her, so yeah, that'll be
can
a part
I look
of
quickly?
This.
I want to be unseen by everyone.
Okay.
And follow her in if she's
I'll
coming
look carefully.
In.
Sure, yeah.
That's one success.
Okay, you don't notice him. He's like come up behind you. Let's see. But you do notice that the lady that goes by you, she has an amethyst pin in her hair, and she just kind of.
I like
you.
Watch her go by. So I have to remember that for later.
And you basically, Crystal, just hiding there behind. I guess you haven't. I'm guessing you haven't like entered the actual place because you're just. I'm just imagining that you're right behind Percy.
She like
yes.
takes out her gun. She looks at it. No, not again. And she puts it away, and then she walks into the generator room.
Okay, so you go there. You pull the lever. It opens up. You go inside, it's generator, there's these consoles over there, there's like, on the corner is a radio, it has like five buttons under it.
Doesn't look like it's off. I'm going to press the first button.
On the radio?
Yes.
Okay, you just get, and are you guys talking? Oh, actually, yeah, you would actually pick up, wow, I was going to turn off myself, but I guess, sure, just do that for me. I'll take advantage of that.
He's gonna yell into the radio. Ah, you're welcome.
What
cool.
are we supposed to be doing?
Wait
this
a second.
Kind of boring channel, and I'm gonna switch to the second one.
Switch to the second one. You just hear like people talking in the background.
Okay, third one.
Again, people, but there's kind of more clattering and stuff.
Can
fourth
I get
one?
Into
there's
this?
Nothing. Can't hear anything.
Fifth one.
Nothing. Again.
Well, I guess the first one is the most interesting then. First one.
Can I, while she's distracted by the radio,
yeah.
sneak in, find a place that I can hide and be still and observe?
Okay. Both of you roll for seeing and then hiding.
Luckily for you, I'm not good at perception. One success.
Okay. Well, it's two successes, I believe. Yes. Two successes.
Right. So you're just hanging in the corner and like in the darkness. of the corner, and Percy just hasn't seen you. Yeah. All right, Percy.
What was it we were supposed to be doing anyway? This doesn't look off.
Perhaps you can turn it off. Also, says a voice on the radio.
Oh, hi.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Pretty good. How are you?
Who are you?
That's the question of the hour, isn't it?
I did ask it, yes.
I think you called me Mr. Fish, was it?
Oh, Halibut. I thought you'd ought to be more specific than that.
Okay, are you going to shut off the generator, or should I?
I don't really plan on it, no.
Okay. And the generator turns off.
I'm going to try and turn it back on.
Roll for understanding how this console works.
Study.
Probably would have to be... Yeah.
Well, carefully?
What I have to for you to do?
I don't know if this would affect anything, but you should look. Nope, metagaming.
Probably is it a whale?
I ain't here.
I use study carefully.
So would my whale's focus count?
You have a whale's focus?
Yes.
Is that even
I don't think so because I doubt that apart. You know how whale oil works, so you know that it's using the whale oil generator around it, but you don't, like, I don't think you looked into how do I use whales to.
How do I
do stuff?
Turn whales' bodies into energy is
why?
Really not Percy's area of
expertise. What? You
yes,
what
I mean in this particular
look at mine.
How do I turn on a generator powered by whale
secret.
Oil? It's not going to
Yeah, no.
I don't know. This thing's going to hide on
anyway,
it.
Anyway, so you can...
Mine's secret, too.
You can probably...
Okay. Probably... Study carefully? No whales focus?
Might be tinker. Actually.
Oh, wait. That's the same.
Okay.
Tinker carefully?
Yeah.
Okay.
So this is gonna be challenging. So three, if you want to add anything or anything. It's very complicated.
Can you use a void point? Your roll.
Okay.
Wait, that's not helpful.
You could.
Is it partial successes?
No, I don't think so. You could try again, maybe.
I'm gonna let it stand instead then.
All right. What do you get? Just one. Yeah. So you're kind of trying to figure out how this thing works. It's kind of beyond you. You're not sure what's going on. You get one. So you definitely are like, I know. Don't do this. Don't do that. Don't do these things. You maybe figure out. Hey.
A list of things not to do.
Yeah. It seems like a lot. Yeah. You kind of know some things of what not to do. That would just be beneficial overall. But you don't know how to turn it back on. The lights are basically out, and there's a lot of people, like, talking in the other rooms.
I'm going to kick it hard.
Yeah, hard. Roll for tinker check.
Would this be fight?
It would be tinker.
Darn it.
You could do it in a forceful way or a quick way or a way
I'll
you would
take,
fight.
I'll take swift. That sounds good. Oh, that's... Okay, that's what I'm talking about. Three successes.
Okay, you kick it. The thing...
Nice.
And it comes back on.
Sometimes the old-fashioned way is the best.
Kinetic calibration.
Great.
Are we coming, arriving here? It's been a while.
Oh, did you guys come back?
Well, we were planning on coming after we shut the engine down.
Okay, so you're heading back that way. You just go by, you're walking by, and just everyone's like, why are the lights out? And like, so you head back down there, and you're following your way. There's a guard, and he's just like, everyone, stay calm, it's all right, everything is all right.
He's gonna wave out and tell them, it's all right, they're just doing repair work.
Repair work? Why are they doing repair work now?
Percy just kicks something.
And then the lights kind of start to flicker back on. Oh my goodness. Oh, that'd be horrible.
Ah, whale bones. Let's go. He's going to walk over towards the other generator. Okay.
You guys go around and you come back, come to the gallery place. So you come around to the gallery and you can just kind of see what's going on. Grand and you're like, looking around just like, what is going on here? And you, of course, notice like the lights go out.
Mm. Ah, yes, technology will fail us. Anyways, Sir Conan Pikeman were a very impressive kind of soldier.
Maybe we need to go do something, I think. So we'll be back. We need to check on something, especially if the lights are going out. We need to make sure our friend is okay.
Oh, your friend? Who is your friend?
The lady, Lyra.
Oh, yes. Well, she did say she was going to her husband.
Okay. Then she's probably just in the mango. Mm-hmm. Didn't come along, Andy. Okay. Bye. It was very nice to meet you.
Of course. And you too, Lady Andy.
Yes. And so they leave, go off. Yeah, and then the lights come back on. You guys come back into the room. You just pass those people as they're leaving. Yeah, so you get to the other room. Percy just kind of leaves. And yeah, you're like, I have no idea how that worked. It worked all right.
You come in, and she turns around, and she's beaming, and she says, all you have to do is kick it, see?
Could I also enter this
room? Ah, it didn't work.
Yes.
And he's going to go over, and he's going to start kicking the machine, too.
No, we want it on.
Roll for
it. He's kicking it.
Roll for it.
What focuses would apply here?
I would take attack or tinker.
Would brawling apply?
Yes, I guess it would.
All right, if that is the case, I believe this may be 3 successes.
Man.
Yeah, this is 3 successes.
Okay, you kick it. It gets dents inside and just... It goes out again.
What did you
and
do?
And just over the radio you hear, well, all right then.
You ape, we're supposed to keep them alive.
And she's going to kick it again.
Stop, stop right, kicking.
Roll again.
I'm surrounded by absolutely insane.
Please get a free.
Oh, no. It didn't work this time.
Did you get?
Stop kicking it.
0.
Maybe I need to go kick the other one, and she's going to, like, start beelining back with the other.
Right. Sorry, I thought you told me to turn the other one off.
No, we're supposed to find out why they're trying to turn them off.
Right. As you're running around, you look over.
The radio?
You're coming around, and you look over, and there's these, like, 2 places where there's, like, these statues, and then there's, like, a window behind it, and you see coming over the fence, like, 5 guys have just leapt over the fence and are just running off into, like, away from where the main thing is. You just
is there anything distinguishable about them?
Roll for sight.
Bad at seeing things. 1 success.
1 success. You don't notice much. They seem like average kind of age. They're like wearing wrappings and they're like wearing kind of clothes to like disguise of stuff. You can see like they're wearing goggles and stuff and like have little masks on, it looks like.
Absolute buffoon. I should never have told him to kick anything.
All right.
She's gonna like go and kick the other generator.
Alright. You actually get into it and the it actually just turns on, and you come into the room, and you see the thing comes on, and this man turns, and he's bald. He has, like, a very, like, hawk-ish nose, and he just looks at you.
You're distinctive.
Were you the one? Wait, hold on a second. Okay, here we go. Were you the one that turned off the generators?
No, I was the one who was trying to turn the back.
Well, good, because we can't turn off the dang generators!
I know, it's a very bad idea. There's 5 people just climbed over the wall.
Climbed over the walls?
What are you doing?
He reaches over and just like, he reaches into his coat and pulls out a gun. We'll see about that.
I like your style, sir. What's your name?
Crown a second.
That's my name.
But it's Joldana Jekyll.
Right. Let me get this guy.
Looks like a Vlad.
My name is Vouch! He goes down, just goes down a passage.
Out of action. I'm gonna like tail along.
Okay, he's just walking. And just looks like, you don't have to follow me! Who are you, strange small girl?
I take out the gun. Someone who wants
to. Oh, you're armed!
Yes.
Then. Do you like killing things?
Dearly.
Awesome, then you can come with me.
I thought so.
You guys are.
Wait, where are they right now?
They have went down.
Oh, they went all the way to the library.
Yeah, so they went through this passage.
All right, I'm.
Did you guys follow? Did you guys see them leaving?
I would have hoped to follow to go to the other generator to turn it back on, but okay. I should have mentioned that earlier.
I'm following.
I'll just go ahead and
recognize the generator. If there's no one else in the room, then I'm gonna leave. But as long as someone's
you know what,
she might not have said some of that if they were in the room.
Right. Yeah.
You probably talked to them, and they were probably coming in.
Yeah. Let's stay out of earshot. I'd also like to keep an eye out for suspicious characters.
Okay. Roll for suspicious characters.
Is everyone out of that one generator room then? Then I'm gonna leave once everyone else is out of that one generator room.
So this is still being stealthy. Could I do this boldly at all?
If you want to, like,
yeah,
make everyone be like, whoa.
Yeah, yeah, I'm absolutely okay with that.
You can do that.
All right, two successes.
Okay, yeah, so you're looking around for any suspicious people.
Yeah. Because this is the opportunity they would use to strike, no doubt.
Probably.
Yeah.
That we just handed to them.
So once I'm out of that one generator room, I'm also going to look for suspicious people as well, but try to keep hidden myself.
Mm. All right, you can roll both. Roll for stealth and then roll for hiding.
Stealth and then what?
Stealth or hiding and then looking around.
Okay.
So trying to find.
Oh boy.
How much? What was yours?
Two successes.
What were the numbers?
It was 5 and 12.
5 and 12. Okay.
I got nothing to see, but I got two successes to be stealthy.
Okay.
What were the numbers?
An 8 and a 16.
Okay.
However, if I'm staying still, I still beat you.
Right. What were the numbers?
I got an 8 and a 16, but as I'm looking, I'm staying still.
Okay.
So I think that would increase the difficulty for anyone else by one.
I thought you were moving out.
So
you're moving when I look at you.
It could
probably
be true.
You're moving.
Well, when I'm looking,
okay,
I'm going to be still.
What,
but I would have
right.
You didn't
yeah.
get anything
so,
for looking. Okay.
I did not get anything for looking.
Okay. And what did you get again?
5 and a 12.
5 and 12.
Oh, two successes.
Mm. I don't like this.
Okay, you.
Would this be worth a void point? You know what? I'm going to say so. Yeah, I'm going to use a void point. Turn that.
Brown upside down?
Yeah, 5 to a critical, so 3 successes.
Okay. Yeah, you see someone, what would have happened?
You definitely see me anyway then.
Let's see.
I'm upset.
Yeah, you see as you're coming down this passage, you just hear something behind you and you like look, and there's a few like little small windows, they're pretty high up, that can like be opened up. And you just, like, as you're running and, like, turning the corner, you just see someone in, like, a little red, like, outfit has just, like, opened it up and just rolled inside and then closed it behind them and then ran down opposite way.
Okay, I would like to, let me know if I can try to do both of these. I saw him. Can I grab his attention and point towards the figure?
Yes. Actually, if you're going slower, you probably would be able to, you don't see this character, but you would probably be able to, like...
Yeah, I'm trying to keep a little quiet, point, and then just run towards this person.
Are you hiding it from the person?
I want to try and kind of fit in as, like, you know, the people in the party are a little hectic because the power just went out and all that. So I wanted to, you know, appear as though I'm, like, you know, just some ordinary party goer that's freaking out. Not someone that's freaking out on purpose.
Okay.
Cool.
Yeah, roll for...
Of course you do.
alerting him. I think that would be...
Probably talk, because it's people.
Talk, yeah.
I suck at that, but...
Yeah, and then however you decide to do it will kind of affect, like, you probably can't do it boldly without the person noticing.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I wanted to do the move to... Hold on.
Then probably it would be talk quietly.
Yeah.
To him.
Yeah, and then move
and
boldly.
Against them, and then move boldly.
Okay. All right. So talk quietly. Oh, it's not the worst. It is. Hold on. Talk. Oh wow, these are my worst scores. That is no successes.
Oh man, but I have an innuendo focus.
Oh. Yeah, I apologize.
Yeah, sure. You can roll.
Maybe
to
it's
see
just
if
muffled
this,
behind the mask or something.
And,
can I roll too? Because I'm technically behind him.
Yeah, you can roll for like, looking around, seeing anything.
Is it flat on the?
It's
yeah, it's flat. Oh wait.
It's like slightly curved. Can I see
it is cocked. Ever so slightly.
Because I'm like right behind him.
Well, that's fine. Maybe I should roll the talk boldly thing first, or the
yeah. So then you would do
move boldly to see if they
three successes.
Okay, you, yeah, you pick up on, like, what he's throwing
down. Alright, yay!
Dude, I'm gonna look wherever he's gesturing.
Yeah, you see someone who's in red, and your paranoia is ding! You don't need to, you're like, I can tell that this person is up to something.
Alright.
They're just running quickly, and they're trying to duck down.
I'm gonna follow them as fast as I can while still being quiet. But I will keep up if they disappear. So.
I'm gonna follow him.
Can I roll my boldly check?
Yes.
Okay.
They will also have a kind of contested to see if they can
one?
See you.
No, I don't see you. Okay. I'm gonna use one more.
Yeah,
momentum.
I had a two on my last one, so.
Wow, that sucks. That is just
quiet.
One. Wait, move boldly. Move. Stop. Man, yeah, that was just a crap roll. Just one success, a 3.
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah. So you go after them. You're running down the hall, and they're just kind of looking behind, and like you just see like they look behind, and they're just kind of like they keep like looking, just seeing if you are keep following them.
Mm-hmm.
They don't seem to have picked up on it yet.
Okay.
Can I?
Okay. So
him?
Everyone, real quick. So, Thomas, have you just continued to the other room?
I was following.
He was following me. I was following him, and he was just following everybody else.
Yeah, I'm following the perp.
I'm following the man in red.
Following.
So everyone's following man in red team, and then we have these guys. So real quick with Percy and the one guy.
We should flank him.
I
don't know how I can relay that.
So, you guys both just go outside. And he has his gun that's with him. He just like waves aside the people who are there and just like the servants. Like, what's going on? He's like, it's fine. I just go. And so he goes around to like look, and he just grabs a guard who's like outside. You go look around the grounds. It seems like there's people on the ground who shouldn't be here. He goes around. He's like, so where did you see them?
They were just climbing over the fence. I saw them at the window.
Mm.
Are you like important or something?
Yes. You know,
yes!
I have a shotgun, and you realize, wait a second, where did he grab that from? And he just is walking out.
You are important.
And he's just walking by. Like, I'm the butt. I was like, I'm the butler. And so he makes it around, and he gets to where, like, where it would be, and he's just kind of going to be looking around. He's like, so, here?
Yeah, roughly.
All right. He's going to be studying around, looking in the area. Yeah, he sees us. Okay, look. Okay.
One success.
There's like, all right, so you're probably both helping, so.
So which butler is this?
This is this bald one with a hook nose, so you probably are like.
Velch. Oh, this is Velch, yeah. But he's, who's Velch. Butler?
Not asked yet.
The butler.
Haven't asked yet. He just says, I'm the butler. He's looking at the friends.
Do you
these
see
are
something?
Footprints. Yep, they're pretty heavy. Probably rather fat. You realize they were not fat.
Mm.
The people I saw weren't fat. They were also very well equipped.
Well equipped. That would probably be it if they had a certain amount of gear. Looks around. They were pretty stealthy.
We're taking a lot of time just standing here.
What?
We're taking a lot of time just standing here.
I'm validating that what you're saying is true so I can trust you, which I probably can. He gives you like a side eye. Rolls.
Yes!
Sees through everything.
You done? You done,
well,
dolls?
Exactly.
Yeah.
I really want to read the full comic of whatever the heck.
He goes
about.
Off just like looking around.
Yeah.
Like, we'll alert the guards. Don't stay on the grounds. They're watering. He just runs away. Do you stand there at all?
Well, for all those guns, that wasn't very helpful. And she'll just kind of stand there indignant for a moment.
Just then you see something like coming towards you that's very tall and on like long limbs, and it has a little watering can attached. And you look over, roll a history check.
Okay. Oh god.
Hey!
No. It's already freaky.
One success, I think.
You're
about to get freakier.
You have heard the tales of the tall boys.
Yeah.
And the suits that they wore. And that they were insane.
Oh, where's
and Brad? The guy walks up and he has a watering can, like.
Is he armored?
He is armored. He has like all the armories and stuff. The only thing is he doesn't have any slingshot or anything, but he comes over and has like this added little piece that has like a watering can on it. He walks over. He has the... Do they wear masks?
I'm just going to stand there.
He
I'm
walks.
Run.
He's just walking over to where you're at. Running just is like pouring water like where you were and then just like starts following you with the watering can.
Gosh.
Well, that's good information for later.
It's a surprise tool.
So I'm going to run back to bed.
Yeah. Roll for running.
Oh, okay. Wait, I'm good at this. Okay.
Move.
Two successes.
Yeah, you get away. You're running. He's just following you kind of purposefully and just keeps like dangling like the water and just eventually stops and just goes about his business.
I'm going to head back inside. Now, if I was a rogue assassin and or follower of this fishhead guy who really seems like he wants attention, if I was to send someone to mess up a ball because I wanted attention, the way that I would do it is probably by like taking hostage someone very important. And Melody was probably the person that's been like the most worried about all this, so I'll probably check in on her first and then kind of like do the rounds with everyone else who seems important.
Where do you want to go?
I'm gonna see if I can find Melody and the others in her family.
Yeah, what room do you want to go to?
Drug room.
Okay, big room.
Big room, then drug room.
Okay, you check in there, you're looking around, the lights are kind of still flickering on and off, and you see people are still pretty like, what the heck's going on? You see Melody and her family are all on like that one table. The bride, you see these people for the first time, the woman, man, the older gentleman, he's talking with one of these guards wearing like an all white kind of outfit, and just talking with them about it. Melody's just kind of like looking around.
Where is the closest like exit from the room from where they are?
There's, from what you can see, there's just the side entrances. There's like a curtain over the like, back of the stage.
I'm gonna go see if I can root someone out behind the curtain.
Okay, you're gonna go up on stage?
Well, around.
Okay, you're gonna go around the stage? Well, you're gonna have to get up on the stage, and there's people playing, and they're still like kind of playing still. Like,
well, surely there's a back way.
You can try and stealth it, but like, it is the stage. It's people look at it.
But could I go to the other room and then sneak around to the other?
Oh, if you
want to
try and go around?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can try and do that. There is like a door that's... There's a door. So basically there's a door right here, or like somewhere here. And when you were running around here, you did see passages that kind of point towards the stage. So maybe...
The stage seems like something our very obnoxious friend Halibut would do.
Hmm. Okay. So you run around. Which side are you going through?
Right side.
Okay. So you run through there. The... People are trying to get the boxing ring going. There's just a guy in there who's like, come on, I'm ready for the fights. They're just delaying it. And like, you go up, like open up the door and like go through. You just go through and there's just a bunch of like doors and like, it's not very, like there's some like nice pitching stuff, but like there's not a whole lot. And behind you, you hear, hey, wait, and like opens up the door, and it's one of the guards. Hey, wait, you can't go through here. This is
I'm actually
quarters.
On a special mission from Melody.
Sure. Please come with me.
Do you want to go ask her? She's like right there, but I really can't be slowed down because there's people trying to kill other people around here. Have you met Valch
yet?
It
is fine.
The butler?
Yes, I know Valch.
He's also trying to find those people. Mm. I was traveling with him a minute ago, and then he got separated.
Okay.
He's a little bit overzealous. Anyway, and she's going to walk through the door.
Well, you're already inside, and like you're walking down the passage, and he's trying to catch up with you. So he's still following. Oh, wait, ma'am.
Yes. Do you want to help? You're welcome to come along if you'd like to.
Hold up, ma'am. He's going to check you. So you're going to roll against him and persuade him. So.
I'm talking very quickly at this point. Which I think has been demonstrated.
Okay.
Two successes.
Well, Okay, I'm going to accompany you. Where are you going?
That's totally fine. I want to poke around behind the stage because I think that that would be the best place to hide someone who is trying to kill someone.
Fine,
else.
But we're going
to
talk to Melody right afterwards, so...
Well, after we find the people that are trying to kill her, sure.
We're going to talk to her first thing. You can tell her all you need to know. And he just leads you over to the left, leads you over, and you look over to the right, and you see, like, an entrance into the kitchen, and you go around to this little kind of storage area. There's a little elevator that's near it, and there's the cloth that's behind it. It says, you can go through there and talk to her.
Great. Thank you. And she's going to do that.
All right. He goes through there. Roll a steady check.
Bad, though. Steady what?
Steady carefully.
Oh, dang, bro. 3 successes.
Yeah, so as you go through, you hear behind you.
I'm going to turn around and...
All right, you turn and look through, and you see the guard is being held by some man behind him, and he's like, trying to struggle against him. The man is, like, pulling him, like, away down the hall, and the guy was taken by surprise, so he's just going down. And the thing just, or the guy looks at you and just, like, sees you and just keeps pulling him.
Well, do you want to drop him?
And then,
the Phelps maneuver. Shoot him in the head.
Well, right, we're going to wait and see first.
Mm. Okay. Hold on a second. And
pulling a trigger is faster than stabbing with a knife.
Yeah. Right. It's true. Guy. Hold on a second. Ooh, that's interesting. Oh, yeah, so the guy who's on it tries to grab the guard's head, but the guard hits him behind him and pushes him off, and the guy stumbles back and then just takes off down
the
passage.
Get out of the way. Oh, man.
The guard pulls out a gun to fire at the guy. Fires. And you see that it's hit the guy in, like, the side, but he keeps going
and
down
also
the passage. All right, roll for...
My 2 attacks?
Yes. Roll for your 2 attacks.
Go for it.
2 successes?
Yeah, you shoot him 2. How much damage do you have?
2. So I'm going to shoot him in the leg.
Shoot him in the leg. Interesting. Yeah, so you shoot him in the leg. You shoot him in the leg, and it makes a really weird sound, like... It just sounds off, and you're like, what was that? And you kind of realize, like, oh, I think he was wearing armor on his leg or something. And he kind of stumbles,
okay.
But he keeps running forward.
Well, second shot, I'd like to go to the head then.
Okay.
Yeah, that works.
You can hit it.
Cool.
2 successes.
Okay, you shoot. He goes down. Hands on the ground.
Now I'm going to kind of just, like, strut down the hallway.
Thank you. And the guard just goes, please go back to where the guests are. And he runs over to where the guy is.
Excuse you, I killed him. I get to look at him. And I'm going to, like...
yes, corpse is corpse.
The guy goes over. Okay.
You're really very rude. Flesh. Especially after it saved your life.
Fine, fine.
And I'm going to, like, flip over the corpse.
Flip over the corpse. And it's a... Somebody's like, they have a mask on with, like, some sort of, like... It looks like there's some sort of... Actually, you saw the... almost like a similar chemical mask that the tall boys are wearing. And it had the goggles on. Mm-hmm. And, you kind of roll over, and it does feel very heavy for some reason, but the body seems to be about normal. You can steady the body now. Anything that you want to look at particularly?
I want to... Okay. I'm trying to figure
Everyone
out how to
roll
say this.
Real quick for trying to catch up with this little red person. I'm not sure if I'm in a red outfit.
So,
running.
This is a move quickly check?
Yes.
Okay.
In my case, can I make a move quietly check? Until I would have lost
okay,
track of
you
him.
Okay, you can do both. One of each.
Okay, one of each.
Rachel?
I would like to, like, see if I can, like, feel armor underneath.
You hit it, and it just instantly you feel, like, metal. And you push up, and what do you hit?
His leg.
All right, his leg. You instantly feel it. You pull up the leg thing, and there's just, like, a robotic leg on that side.
I'm gonna pull off the mask.
You pull off the mask, and it's just like this. You kind of like pull back because the face is just like really white. There's a lot of veins and stuff, and the eyes are just staring dead.
But not a robot.
Not a robot.
Is the other leg and the other two arms robotic?
Yes.
Is the torso robotic?
There's a metal piece that's been embedded into the back that goes up to like the neck. But yeah, these are all things. Roll a study on these the mechanisms.
Yeah,
this
no.
will be
nothing
challenging. Okay, nothing. She just knows that
they're cyborg
limbs and stuff.
Well, they still die just the same. I guess it's all right.
Yeah.
Do you want to go like hide that?
Yes, I'll take it. Can you go just into the party or something?
Well, there's like four more of those. I'd rather shoot them too.
There's four more? Okay. Go find another guard and tell him what's going on.
I'll just take care of it. Don't worry.
No, tell the guards.
Well, listen, if another one does what he did with you, then I don't want to shoot him.
Listen, just tell the guards they'll help you, okay? He just drags him over to a room.
But you want much help. And then she's going to keep going.
It's grumbling and just pulls the body into one of the rooms.
Where else would I hide?
What did you guys get on your rolls?
One
success.
Two.
One success. Successes.
I got nothing for the move swiftly, but I got two for the move quietly.
All right, you're not seeing. You guys are falling behind. You actually catch up. Or actually, you guys are keeping up pretty good. They have a bit of a head start. You actually catch up to where they are, and you're in reaching distance of them.
The butcher's going to yell, "Where are we going?" He doesn't know we're chasing somebody yet.
Yep. I'm just going to say, "Stop, infiltrator!" and attack.
Okay. What are you going to attack with?
My sword.
Okay.
Wow.
So.
Is this within view of me? Or would I be too far behind at this
point?
You're too far behind.
We,
you can roll for it if you want.
Yeah. Are we able to see it?
No.
I rolled perception. No. I got...
Ooh, I got a one.
I got three successes.
It shout at the top of my lungs, stop infiltrator.
Yeah, so you see what they're doing. You see kind of there's this person.
For perception, I got one success.
So
I got
what
a one.
You roll on the attack?
Real quick, just because there's something that might actually affect the attack, is this guy carrying anything? Or what equipment can I see that he has?
You can see that they're wearing like just kind of like a red, kind of dark red kind of suit mask. Or they're carrying like a bundle with them.
Mm-hmm.
That's about it.
You're
not sure if they have anything else on them.
Yeah, okay.
They have gloves and stuff.
All right, so I am going for the arms, basically, to knock this bundle out of his hand. So I get 3d20s for an attack that's about an equipment, or removing a piece of equipment. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 3 successes.
All right, you instantly just cut down, like, and let go of it. Just the thing locked. Drops onto the ground. They pull back. They pull out a like mask and pull out something.
That
like,
is 2 points of damage as well.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you cut their arms like where they are. They instantly just pull out a mask, pull out something from the hand, and throw it down. And it's a smoke bomb. And then they take off. You are.
I do get three attacks.
Okay.
If you want to, you can interrupt. You are the GM.
No, go for your attacks. See that they're pretty badly hurt by that. You just cut them with like a sword. So they're like going down. So they're in bad shape and you're like, oh, I could finish this job.
Yeah. could I hit him with the flat of my blade? So
yeah, you could do that.
Try to hit him in the head and knock him out. That is just I think he might be able to contest this since this is melee.
Okay.
That is just one success.
Okay.
And it's a 14.
Yes. They also get one success, but it's an 11.
Okay.
So I think they get... So they just pull back, and just it goes over them. They pull back up. A good spinal.
All right. Wow.
Yeah.
Acrobat! And final attack is going to be four successes.
Ooh. Well,
dodge this!
Kill him!
Yeah. They have, you know, one success.
Okay. Do I get three momentum for that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Or. So it's four?
Uh huh.
You get.
That I didn't use momentum on that or any four points.
So. So you get three momentum.
Okay, I'll take
you basically, like, swung your sword. They ducked. You're like, oh yeah? You just charge for him and just body them. And they go and
bury
just,
this!
Hit the ground and they're down and out.
Okay.
Gather round.
We're running up behind him. He's pulled his cleaver knight out, and he's, like, screaming down the hall.
Don't kill him! Ah! We have a prisoner. I'm going to take a look at the bundle that this guy has.
Okay, you pick up the bundle and pull out this... roundish object has a bunch of like, spike. You're not sure what it is. Roll tinker check on this. You guys also catch up to this
weird roundish object.
I'm just gonna start
still
poking them in the face, poking him in the face with my cleaver knife.
Can someone bind him? Also, can someone help me identifying
this
object?
His arm and bites.
He picks up his arm and bites him.
That will wake them up. They have. They reach in and pull out the smoke. And throw it down.
Wait, I have their arm. My teeth are sunk into their arm.
Yeah.
What the heck, man?
They still throw it down, and they're going to try and break away.
Okay.
I'm going to get a mouthful of metal. I hope.
Are you a cannibal?
No, but you told me to bite him.
I said bind him!
Well, I misheard in real life and in game.
Man. All right.
Bite him.
What'd you get?
I said bind.
Okay. Yeah, they try and pull away. You both are like blinded by this. They didn't get the mask on. And you, they try and pull away. You still have like your teeth in them. I think you guys don't get like paralyzed and blinded by this. Well, not paralyzed, but like blinded by this. You guys probably do get blinded by it. You can do your tinker check.
Can I make a survive check with this?
Yes. Everyone asks you to do survive checks.
I do believe Thomas was helping me
identify. Would I be close enough to do survive checks? Am I? How close am I now?
Woo!
I feel like you were pretty far away because you were kind of sleeping. So I think you're good. Yeah,
could I add resilience to this?
Resilience?
Yeah. Okay.
That is the physical one.
Three successes.
One
success.
I just got that in the...
You're blinded. You're not...
Three successes.
You're not... Yeah, this only blinded
them. My eyes.
I apologize. I really need the status bonus. Do I get any momentum from this?
Yes. Oh, yes.
Okay.
Me too.
Actually, take one.
Okay.
What was the difficulty?
We'll just do two. So you can take another one.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, so you have this character. We're running a little bit over, so it's okay if it goes like 6:30 or 9:30 or something like that.
Go for it.
All right. You actually, just a real quick thing, as you're running back to, or where are you again?
I'm just looking for more of those guys.
More of those guys. You run down the passage, I'm guessing? Like to where the fighting rink is?
I wouldn't think they would be out in public. So I'd be searching the back holiday, or hallway still.
Okay,
back
so you probably go around to the
back hallway.
Arbor Day and stuff, you know?
Yeah.
You go around to the library you run into, and you see Osiris is just like, has the zoomies. He's just like, what the heck's going on? I'm going to roll something real quick to see if this happens.
Oh, sorry, it's all right. And I'm going to like try to call him the cat town. It's all right, you know me.
Roll for
I'm
calming.
Great, I like cats.
All right, let's see. Roll for calming.
Osiris, will we ever be your second love?
Who's my first?
Your whale. What was his name? Was it like Tammy or something?
No.
Eddie?
Also roll for looking.
Two successes for the cat.
Okay, you calm him down.
I'm gonna like pick up the cat and put the cat on my shoulder.
He just kind of like hugs you.
This is great. I'll protect you. Don't worry. I'm very good with this gun.
He looks a little concerned, but he's okay.
It's okay. I would never use it on you.
Shoulder off the second you fire that gun.
One success for the perception check.
Okay, you hear someone yelling, help, what?
Oh,
like
I run towards
okay,
it.
You run down the passage and you just look, and it's a dark
scarf.
Room. You roll for that. You guys, you're in the room. They've been blinded and they're awake. You're biting them. They are like, get off of me, stop biting me. what did you get on the?
Oh, the tinker check I didn't quite make. I think Thomas was, you were assisting me, right?
Yes, but I've been blinded.
Oh, okay, yeah.
I'm
you,
like,
can't,
oh!
You can't quite look, okay.
Can I make an attack on him?
Guess,
object.
They are like, they have no energy. This would be like, knock them out for a while or dead.
Yeah, I have no idea where this thing is. No successes.
Yeah,
I will keep it though.
I'm gonna grab their head and like smash it into the floor.
What are you gonna try and do with this?
I'm not sure. He's just biting this guy, and he just tried to blind me, and I'm mad, so I'm just smashing his head.
He does notice that if he does this, and he does it well, they're dead.
Okay, well, hopefully I don't do it too well.
Okay, they will try and contest this with everything they have.
Josh, do you have some, like, pent-up rage or something?
No.
Is this like...
Oh, no.
Apparently you better do well. You better do well here.
Oh, no.
Apparently
oh,
he does.
No.
This is why I have
to... pent-up rage for sure.
Where is this?
Quit rolling the red dice if you're not trying to kill someone.
Yeah, let's see. No,
those are the murder dice. That's like when I roll this set of dice. Like, I'm trying to kill someone if I roll this set of dice. The blood die and the seer die?
Right.
You know I'm going for blood.
Right.
So I'm
going for
death.
I mean, my character does have pent up rage, so, I mean, it makes sense.
You have pent up rage.
No, I don't.
Yeah, you do.
Okay, how many did you get?
Oh, yes, I do.
How many did you get?
Three.
Okay. Basically, as you're doing that, there's like some dust on their face, and they like pull it off and like flick it where you're making noise, and so they kind of get some dust in your eyes. This is like streetwise fighting, which is why I allow street fights with this. And so you hit them, but it's a little like oh, and you're done, and they're out basically, and that's it. So
pocket sand.
There's some blood. That's still
he's still
that.
Holding his arm in his
yeah,
teeth. And he's not gonna let go.
Okay, cool.
And he's just looking.
Source,
he just looks
Rachel
up. He just looks up at Adrian with the guy's arm in his teeth.
Am I still blind? Bind him.
I, like,
don't bite him. Bind.
Like,
tie him and restrain him with ropes or something. Speak a bit more clearly next time. But that's what I do.
He flips him over.
Were there more here? Were there more here?
Of what?
Of the people.
No, you don't see any, you just see this one person. You don't see anyone else. There are people who are like, a few people are just, and they just run by, but they're just panicking.
Are there further
There's
back...
a few people who are just like, okay, we don't need to panic, what the heck's going on?
Are there
on?
Further back hallways?
Let's see, you have, let's see, so you're right here. There's a direct place to the kitchen. You see a guard that's standing, and you see the gallery. You see a hallway of a bunch of doors. You see a little another doorway that seems to lead to the kitchen, another that seems to be some room, and a hallway down. So that leads to somewhere else. So
I'm going to go in the direction that seems least populated.
Okay. Yeah, you go into a little store place. You just walk into there. There's some food, there's things, there's a big, like, there's something that has, like, a big leather, like, blanket over it.
I will remove the leather blanket.
Okay, you remove the leather blanket, and it falls away, and there's dust and stuff, and roll a check. It's gonna be harder because you don't have a good memory, and this is specifically something that will, well... I'll say the fact that you may have seen these means that you'll have disadvantage for remembering it. But if you have any history or anything like that, you can do it. I'm going to say this is challenging, so it's a 3 to figure out what this is.
What are you doing this on?
I don't know. Thing I just unearthed.
Use a 4 point.
I'm so mad that neither of those is a 1, but I am using a 4 point. Because that's too close not to. So 3 successes.
All right, you look at this thing, and it is a, well, it has one thing missing. There's a blade missing. Besides that, it's a perfectly created clockwork soldier that's just standing there.
Does it appear to be activated?
It seems to be idling.
Would I know how to deactivate it permanently?
Roll again for that. Same check.
Same check, same difficulty?
Yeah, probably. Because
these are FYI.
These are things that you might see.
The hardest NPCs in Dishonored, other than the Outsider himself.
Wait, what would this check be?
This would be probably Tinker. Any history things would probably be good. Cleverly.
Oh, I got a critical success, but that's it.
Okay, critical success. With that, you do notice there's like these little, on the back, are these little oil, whale oil canister things. So you're like, oh, that's got something to do with this.
I'm gonna take them out.
It moves away from you, and like, it moves its head at you. Like, it points away from you, but you see there's a little optic, and it's looking at you, and just moves away.
So wait, where was this thing?
It was in a little storage room. It's near storage. Where there's this elevator and there's the cloth that's in front
of it. Does it seem to be actively against me right now?
No, it just doesn't. It doesn't want you to mess with it. Kind of self-preservation you're maybe picking up on.
I'm gonna...
Real quick, with Percy, you run in, you run down the hall, and you see the fighting rink, and behind that, you're going to look around, the room is dark still, things are going on, there's a lot of people pushing even by you, and you're like, I need to see what's going on, so you need to roll for seeing.
Oh, so bad at seeing. Seeing what? Seeing quickly?
Yes.
That brilliant, be... two.
Two.
Oh, I could see quickly, Anton, I'd see everything.
I'm
being persuasive.
Just have them
roll. Instead of Anton, I'm like, it's no success.
You see, yep, going right. By you, and they do get by you, it looks like three people, and they're carrying someone who has been tied up, and they just...
Oh,
I'm going to run after them.
You run after them. Oh, they're just following.
Do you want to get
one
shot?
One looks behind, and...
And I'm going to pull out my gun.
One looks fine. One pulls away from it and says, now, dearie, I would say for you not to do that. And it's Grand Grand.
Oh, it's you. Sorry about that. Can I come with?
Sure. Come on.
I'm going to follow.
Sure.
Grand Grand.
They go into the library and they start heading upstairs. So that's where they go. But you see who's tied up. And it's Derby. And he's all tied up and gets, and he like sees you. And then,
no!
And gonna, take
I will
follow.
Kill anyone that lays a finger
them.
On Derby!
Okay, they all go up there. So they all have
their time.
So, real quick, we're going to have last scene with Barbie. What you guys are doing. So you guys are all around this one person, and chaos is going on, people are running around. What do you
do
guys
do?
Do
we hear
do?
The gunshots that she's been firing?
Maybe not. There's a lot of chaos, also it's a big house.
Is there anything to tie this guy up with? Like tablecloths.
There's a tapestry next to you that has these little tassels on it to like go down.
Well, she said we could take anything in the house. And I'm just going to take the little laurels or whatever they are down and tie this guy as best as I could.
Yeah.
As I can.
Yeah, so you do that. So you tie them. Roll a tinker.
Probably tinker.
Yeah. Can someone help?
I'll help.
I'll try.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Tinker. Cleverly.
Forcefully.
Complication.
Or forcefully. Yeah, let's do it forcefully.
All right, you...
Well, let me see. Oh, no successes.
One success.
Yeah, nothing counts, unfortunately. If I roll no successes, no one can help at all.
You
it really
dislocate
sucks.
Your jaws and just, like, kind of...
I dislocate my jaw?
No, you...
Wait, what?
Not dislocate your jaw, but, like, your bite.
I released my bite.
You released your bite. That's what I meant.
I was like,
and
how?
You just throw down the arm, and it just... It's them in the... What the... And they come up again. Oh,
what do you want for?
You tie them down like they can't move. Right.
I'm going to ensure that he can't untie himself. I'm going to pull my cleaver knife and try to cut his thumbs off.
No!
No!
Oh, they can get out easier.
They pull in and like
he's
tuck into
the whole thing off.
I'm going to try and stop him from
doing
it.
Okay. Yeah. Thomas is going to stop
I'm adding
him too.
Momentum.
Okay.
Thomas
fine.
Is going to stop him.
Do that.
Hey, what am I rolling for?
You have momentum too.
I do, but I'm not going to use it for a dumb check like this.
Yeah, I definitely
you,
got
that. Yes, you are gonna do
no.
This.
The man's
I'm
left my thumbs
no,
are
not
taking
like,
you
this
don't
part
use
off. This
your
is the part
momentum.
Bone that like makes it harder to like slip off.
Well,
I'm gonna cut
thumbs.
Like right here.
Such
at the
a knight.
What'd
you
get?
Three successes.
No
what numbers?
He's just
three
like
and 12.
Historian. I got no successes.
I got 2 and 11.
No.
Yes.
You do get 2 chaos for that.
No, you didn't do it. I stopped him.
Okay.
I got no successes, but so I guess I just kind of waved my arms around and yelled, stop.
Listen, we've tormented him enough.
This is pretty like, stop it, Jimmy.
Yes!
Dennis got his thumbs off. Right. I have a weak stomach. Right. I'm telling my father. Oh,
wait, real quick, you guys are in.
Please look out
for me. What do you work for? Why do you work for?
Answer, I'll cut off your thumbs.
What are you having? Ben, what are you having?
Flagbreakers.
Flagbreakers, what's your mission, Flagbreakers? What are you doing here?
I'm just bringing that thing.
What is this thing?
I don't know. It's supposed to mess with the electronics. There's something. There's like a big metal man that can fight for us.
Metal man.
I'm right here! I am the metal man!
He's gonna grab his
hand.
He's got his hand and he's got his like cleaver above the thumb.
Like a mechanic!
Answer.
Can I insight check him?
Yes.
It's not gonna yield anything, but I might as well try. That's one success.
He's like slowly putting
Okay.
He's slowly putting pressure
on the
thumb.
Butcher, please. I have a weak stomach, please.
Close your eyes.
No, I already, can I put the powder back in my eyes?
When he said metal man, could I do a history check to see what he was talking about?
Put it back.
Or is this more of a tinker?
Probably like, more like talking, so like, talk. Oh, just like that.
Okay.
You wanna, talk
about it. All right, that's gonna be anything less than a nine.
Yeah,
hey,
I'm gonna,
two successes.
To the clockwork soldier, and just gonna be like, "What are you programmed to do?"
Hello, dear. It's your father. I just wanted to present this lovely item to you as the sword to cut your wedding cake with.
I love
it. It's a terrible gift. Why on earth would someone do that? I'm pretty sure if someone gave
please
someone like that
this,
a gift, give to someone and like help them over
please
throw
step aside.
Someone,
this is a safe
even if you're on the throne or something,
it
but that would never
to
happen.
Cut the cake.
It's a good thing it would
please
never happen.
Please step aside.
These
this is a safe thing
to
use.
To
is
the
fine
throne.
To cut the cake. The thing then like turns and starts walking down the hall.
No,
like, it goes.
I'm gonna
down
try
the
it. I'm gonna like try to get the whale oil out.
All right, it. It's moving away from you. It's going to. It's basically, if you're doing that, it starts like to like defend itself, possibly hit you with its swords. So this would be a fight situation.
Man. I know.
It does have one sword gone, so it's just three swords.
Oh, okay.
That's not helpful though, because those will all have a strike on you.
So it seems like now it's upset.
It seems a little peeved. If you want to like. Check to see how it's feeling. I guess we could do that.
Yeah, I'll check. I'll inside check a robot. I got a critical success.
Okay.
Ready to hold it.
How good is this thing at hiding its emotions, I wonder?
No, all of it wants.
Chubby Bunny challenge. Say your character's name.
What do you get?
I got one critical success.
Okay, you see that it's definitely trying to leave and it seems upset.
I have to do maintenance on you.
It's trying to get through the doorway and that's kind of slowing it down.
I was told to do maintenance on you. You're not done yet.
It like breaks a bit of the wall and like continues down the passage and walks down. Okay.
Okay.
It walks down towards where you guys are at. Actually, so what's your role? A big metal man, but you see like the big metal man has just walked. You just see a clockwork soldier. You have a history, you know history things, and this is a clockwork soldier that is walking down the hall that has one thing missing.
I'm going to break that object that guy brought with him.
I'm going to cut his thumb off.
Okay.
Who, the guy?
Yeah.
No, I have a weak stomach.
Please, no, stop.
No, I said later I was putting my knife on his hand and threatening
Thomas him. Thomas reaches as a futile attempt.
My hand's right. I'm gonna.
Can I roll for
you guys? No, yeah, you roll for speed. Both of you guys roll for speed. and attacking. What do you guys do?
I'm just trying to shatter the thing that he said would disrupt the big metal man. Put it on the ground and I'll just stomp on it.
I have one success.
Roll an attack against it. What'd you guys
do? I got a 3 for cutting his thumb off.
I got a 1 success.
I believe he might be able to resist as well.
He's still walking though.
This is a fight. This is a fight. Quickly. Oh.
Yeah. I got
I'd say maybe.
Actually,
yeah,
wait. I got.
Fight quickly.
No, wait. If it's fight quickly, I got 2 successes.
Okay. Do you have any void points?
I have 3 void points.
No man's life.
You could try
using that. You're going to use a void point on this to save the guy's thumb?
No, I will.
You used momentum on this heck last time.
I have 2 success for the climbing. I put it in and I was like, this was a bad idea. I was like, you know what?
I tried.
If I don't if I start laughing, it's going to get worse.
Well, I'm just cutting off the one for now, and I'm going to look at Thomas and hold the thumb up. And when Thomas runs away from the severed thumb, I'm going to chop the other one off.
Two more chaos. They look...
I chop the other thumb off.
Thomas is sobbing in the corner because his life has been ruined.
Hold on a second. Before that, man.
What? Hold on. Hold on.
First, Atri.
Yes.
Do that. What do you roll?
2 successes.
2 successes. I'm not sure quite how objects work, but that looks like a pretty good roll. It hits it, it just like dent a little bit, and this red kind of glow comes out, and it just kind of zaps a little bit of your like foot, and you're like, oh, it's like looks like electricity, but like red. Nothing really happens, but you're like, whoa, that's weird, and the clockwork soldier just. And it just charges you, and it has its swords, like, straight towards you.
What is it? Okay. I hit this thing with my foot.
Whenever,
I don't try to keep hitting it.
Whenever it does that.
Maybe we should roll for
move
quickly.
I'm gonna sprint after it and take out my sword.
Okay. So you do that. You're probably gonna catch up to it. It's pretty close. Okay. We'll try to get a place where it calms down a little bit. Okay, so what are you doing? All right, the person's pleading with you, and the mask actually falls, and you see that this is just a young girl who now has a, stop, anything!
You're
going to
chop
like,
the other thumb off.
All right.
We're literally being attacked right now, and you're torturing a prisoner.
You said you loved this 2 seconds ago.
That is fair, you kind of did.
Well, I thought it was just some random dude or something.
Okay.
It's different.
You can't just assume someone's gender.
He's not stopping to see if it's a guy or a girl. If he doesn't care, his heart has been broken by a woman before.
What gang did you say she was a part of?
Yes.
You said it was a something sales?
Absolutely.
It's not
military.
At least I'm not cutting anyone's thumbs off.
Flag breakers?
Yeah.
Flag breakers.
I got 3.
That's not versus style.
I got 3 successes. Do I get any momentum from that?
Toes off one by one as an intimidation strategy.
Hold on a second.
Because I think he could.
She actually, yes, she has a bunch of stuff near her, but call it chaos. Call it what you will. She pulls out something and she throws it in your face and it smashes and it is acid in your eyes. You cannot see currently.
Can I contest this at all?
Yeah, you can try and move quickly. To get out of the way, it might still hit you. Unless it's
okay,
really good.
I didn't. It hit me. Can I roll a resilience check to see if it actually blinds me?
Yeah, sure.
Oh.
Okay, I rolled a success and a complication.
Okay. So the acid doesn't hit you, but like a bit of glass just cuts you, and you're like ah, and you're like huh, didn't hit my eye, ha, and then the blood starts getting in your eye, and, ah, no! So you can probably do that, but you have to put a hand up to, like, keep the blood out of your eye, so you would have one on thing. So you kind of have to, like...
He's just going to try to chop the thumb off with
his
eyes closed.
She pulls away and just tries to roll away, basically, and is going to try and run off as this thing's coming at you guys. And, Atri... Okay, who is in front of it? Atri, you 3 guys...
Well, can I...
You
can
all
I
need to roll an attack... roll because this thing's charging you and it's just gonna like try and just cut anything that
she's trying
at you
she's
and it's aiming like so it's gonna try and hit.
She's trying to get away. Can I like grab her and roll so that she's like a human meat shield between me and the charging thing with swords?
Yes, you can do that.
Cheese and crackers, man!
Do you want to do anything? Do you want to do anything?
I want to tackle him. Everyone,
do you? You realize
basically,
that you cannot tackle him.
Okay.
It's not enough time, but you can move yourself in front and take any blow.
I will
you
do
will
that.
Not be able to roll
I will
against
do that.
This guy. That's
yeah.
This thing that's coming at you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm
just ready to defend.
All right, yep. Thomas,
the weak and the helpless, which she's currently.
Yes.
1 success.
No thumbs. Weak.
For
used
what was that fight?
Helpless.
Mm-hmm.
Forcefully. Yes. Was that what I was going for? Yeah, so I got one success.
A little girl with no thumbs.
let me just pull up this guy real quick.
Butcher has issues.
It comes at you.
I figured.
Really?
Take a look at the
Is
this?
They look pretty good, but
he carves humans like
normal. Maneuverability, that's right. Hey, sturdiness.
Okay, that. Okay.
Can you store stuff underneath it?
That is two successes. You take. What does this bad boy do? You take a 3. It just kind of cuts you across, and just okay. If you have armor, it hits that first. And but you're kind of thrown aside. Butcher, what did you? Or you're behind everyone, so you're okay.
Well, I'm grabbing the redheaded or the red.
Yeah, and
little
then he's
red
blocking. So you guys are all kind of there.
Yes.
He hits you with a 3 to damage.
Could I contest this?
Yeah,
I do have
sure.
a shield.
With your shield, yeah, can do that.
All right. Yes. Okay, I'm gonna reroll one of those because I got a sword and a shield. That is 2 natural ones, so that's 4 successes.
Okay, you actually, you hit him off. Balance and actually, Tim, you actually only take 2 because that actually hits him off, and so he doesn't do one of his damages. So you just take 2 stress instead. It does reach down and just uses its like the one that doesn't have a sword on it. It just mm-hmm. stabs into the place that you had broken it in, and it just lifts it up and takes off running.
Okay.
And then so, you guys start hearing clicking or like from both sides of the passageway. And actually, you roll a paranoid check.
Okay. So, I'm a little confused about what happened to it. Did we take off one of its sword arms, or just like
you just destabilized?
Oh, okay, sword yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Thomas, all right.
Awesome.
What did you get?
Good.
I think
one. You would have gotten this no matter what, but the one you see that there are 2. Actually, there are 3. These guys standing behind you. They don't seem to be armed with anything, and then you see that there are 4 coming towards where the thing just runs past, and 4 other guys are walking towards on the other direction. There are 7 people coming all around, and there's actually another place where the gallery is, and there's 2 guys who are walking towards you guys, and you guys hear this like clicking and stuff, and you guys just look up, and all of them just their arm, like their hand gets pulled back, and a gun comes out or a knife, and they'll like aim at you. And then you hear, well, 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 and one just steps forward. And you see there's like a little collar that has like a little radio on it. Wow, things got really are getting off and getting spicy. You, I got a gift. And someone hands him a bag and he just pulls forward. You can see that these guys are wearing these glasses. They have these masks on with like a little oxygen things. They're covered and you probably noticed at least, yeah, you've probably definitely noticed that they all have these robotic hands and these like clockwork hands they look like. But this guy lifts up this bag and he just throws it at your face. You can try and grab it or it's just gonna hit you in the face.
Is he tossing it for me like?
He's just throwing it at you.
Well, I'm gonna lift
like, you can
little Red
it.
Riding Hood up and cover my face
okay.
and let it hit Red Riding Hood.
Yeah, it just hits her.
He's gonna look in the bag.
We don't use human shields. Put it down.
You open up the
He's
bag.
He's got her in a headlock.
And just a hand drapes out, and there's the thumb missing. And he goes, you're going to have to do a little bit more than that to impress me.
All right. He pulls the knife out.
And the guy just walks towards you like this.
Bring it on, fat man.
Oh, I was talking about her.
I don't care. Do you think I care at all? About what happens to her. She's just a pawn.
If you're gonna fight, then fight one-on-one. Put her
Shut
out
up,
of us.
Knight. He's gonna throw her to
No!
He's gonna throw her to the side.
Okay, you can catch her if you want to.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you just
Absolutely,
catch
yeah.
her. You just
okay.
Her.
He's gonna, like,
just put her carefully.
She just, like, grabs and just holds on to you.
Okay.
I'm so sorry.
He's gonna walk with his cleaver knife
you can
over
roll,
at...
like, cover...
yeah, yeah. Stop right. the bleeding, yeah. All right.
He walks up.
He's gonna, like... Yeah. Strut over there with his knife, and he's gonna go and stop like 5 feet away from him.
1 success in the bandage.
So, what are you gonna do? I'm gonna fight all my skitters? And he just like points behind him at these, like, that's what you can't get, like, oh, that's what these guys are called. Hmm?
I know, I was figuring we'd fight
1-on-1.
There is a rink.
Bearing a cold. And just lifts up. Sorry, I don't have those. And you see he has metal arms. And you realize that, you know how brass knuckles work. This is basically embedded.
He puts his cleaver knife away and pulls out his own set of brass knuckles, puts them on, and like hits them together.
Bring it on.
And then so.
Is there a way for me to disappear?
They probably, they maybe haven't seen you. Maybe, you notice that they're like coming in like actually even from, it looks like the ceiling. So you think if I run really fast, get a really high roll, probably 3, I could get through and just kind of slide through and like get away. You also see Osiris, and he just sees you and starts like running in and meow, 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 meow.
Wait, hey.
Osiris,
kitty cat.
Stop the fight, guys.
Guys,
pause.
The cat.
The cat run away?
So no, I'm sorry. Yeah,
if I stayed where I am.
Osiris is not there to help.
Yeah.
You have Osiris.
If I
Thomas creeps
stayed
closer to gently pet the
where
cat.
I am, would they definitely see me, or might I be able to
there,
sink up against the wall or in an alcove or something?
There are a bunch of doors, so maybe if you go quickly, you could like get into one. There is that tapestry that you could just slip behind.
I'll go behind the tapestry.
Okay, you can roll for that.
Move quietly.
Swimming. You can make your first attack.
Yeah, he's a swimmer. All right, wait, before I do... And he's gonna, as he's like pulling out his brass knuckles, he's also gonna pull out some chewing tobacco and stick, like, take some chewing tobacco and start chewing that.
He just like, the guy does like something to his mask and just, one more smoke. 3. I'm gonna see if any of them.
And once I'm behind there, I'm gonna try to stay as still as possible so that no one can see me move or anything.
Does the flag breaker have any more smoke grenades on her?
She has 2.
Okay.
Still.
Sorry, I might need these. Can I take those?
She doesn't do anything. She actually opens it up, and you see there's some, like, looks like darts that are in there. I'm not sure how many, but like, it seems like there's a few darts. She's like,
are they, like, poison darts, or, like, what are we talking about?
You're not sure what they are, but they do seem like darts that you would shoot people.
Okay.
Yeah.
Take a couple of those for further analysis.
Yeah. So this guy's looking at you. They don't notice at all.
Nice.
This guy.
I'm going to swing my first punch. He's going to, all right, for flavor, after he swings, he's going to, like, try to feint a right hook, and then he's going to do a left jab.
Okay.
Let me know if anyone gets close enough for me to strike them from my hidden position while somewhat remaining. All
right. What'd you get?
Just 2.
He actually just doesn't do anything and just takes the hit.
I'm gonna swing again.
All right.
I have 3 attacks.
He's gonna try and contest this.
3 successes.
Oh. Let's see. Fight.
Each hit does like 2 damage because he's got brass knuckles.
Got it. Again, nothing. He tries to block it, but shoot him again. Where are you hitting him?
Does he have armor on his face?
Kind of. Yeah. I mean, they have some like glass things and like.
He's aiming for the glass to try to break the glass.
Okay. Yeah, so you roll again, you hit. Is this your, how many times do you get to punch?
3.
Okay, so this is your last time doing that.
He's gonna punch once more. 2 hits.
What is the 2 successes?
6 and 8, 2.
He gets a critical
for
one, so he just blocks it with his,
your
one of his arms,
focus.
And then he goes
in. Oh, did I get any momentum for my first, or for my second hit? I got 3 successes.
What would it have to be for you to get 1?
Momentum. Okay. He hits your arms over, and the other hand switches to a knife, and he slashes at you with it.
Right. I should probably ask that. 4.
Well, no, because my focus is 5, so I get whatever the highest amount is.
That's... Do you get 3?
So probably, yeah.
1 success.
2.
Okay, so he slashes, misses you. He comes at you again. Slashing back this time. Two successes.
2.
Both of his are 9s.
11 and 12.
Alright. So he slashes you. That's a 2 for damage.
Great.
Fire! Oh.
Fights again. Last one.
3.
6, yeah. She misses.
Do I get any momentum for that?
So you get 2 momentum, or you can try and counter him. So that would be like you would try and do an attack at this point.
That was his last attack, right?
Yes.
I'm not gonna bother countering, I'm just gonna start attacking. Alright. I am going to swing.
All right.
goal!
Alright. A success and a complication.
Yeah, so. Yeah, got you hit him. Anyway. He's not thanks to him. Complication. So like you swing to hit him, and you kind of move, he moves like you hit his arm, and you're like, okay, but you actually hit it, and you go pretty, feels like it goes deeper than it should, and you try and pull out, and your brass knuckle is caught, and so you pull it away, and you only have like one brass knuckle now. Like, oh, okay.
I'm going to hit him with my other hand then.
All right. Guys.
Maybe later.
One success.
All right, you try and punch the other way, mm-hmm. and he tries to move, and you actually, like, your fingers are out, and you actually move, and, like, you're like, oh! And he, like, kind of dodges, and you scoop up the other brass knuckles, and you're like, oh, that was cool. He rolled a complication. And you just backhand him, and you take him out, and as you hit him in the head, how do you want to do this?
Nice.
Is this a knockout?
Whatever you want it to be.
All right. So he's going back, but he's gonna like swing with his elbow.
Okay.
And like.
What do you want to do with this? Like, what are you trying to do?
He's just going for the most. Yeah, he's just trying to, I guess. Just the most epic knockout. Just wants to send him flying back, so he lands on his head.
Okay. Yeah. So you hit him. He goes back, hits his head, and there's blood, and he just goes down.
Ah, who's next?
The guys with all the guns just pull it out and just.
Ah, and he's gonna run to the side.
Gentlemen, your leader lost. It's the rules of combat.
And they just all start moving back. Fine, says one. And then another one. Yes, of course. Yeah, because you think that I'm gonna show up and fight you myself? Not yet. Another one. I'm still here. I hope you all have a fun time. And they all. And just run off.
Do any of them pass by me?
Cowards!
Where I'm hiding.
I feel like it's a little bit in there. It's like you're in the circle that they're around. So they don't run by you. They just like go.
Okay.
No, I'm going to account for that showing up to their own fight.
Cool.
Alright. Real quick, last thing. You guys, so you're holding her. They just all run off. Do you guys do anything?
Yeah, could we talk to her?
Yeah, she's very, like, not doing well.
Where'd the Clockwork Soldier go?
The Clockwork Soldier ran down the passage with the thing on his, and it's doing that thing, and it just tucked in and just disappeared.
Okay, I'm going to put my sword away and kind of, like, try to leave my position as if I was never there. Like, make it seem like I just walked down the hallway rather than hid behind a tapestry.
I think in this case, you... they're pretty distracted and everything's going on. And so I'm just gonna
go in the direction that the Clockwork Soldier went.
Alright. So you have her. She's just on the ground. She's just reaching in, pulls out an elixir, just pours a little on her hand. She's still down, like
it was her right thumb that I took off first,
yeah,
by the way.
So her right thumb is gone.
Who is the man on the radio? The one that said that he doesn't care if you live or die?
I'm not sure. I think he's leader of the... I think he's leader of the Broken Flags. That doesn't make sense, though. Unless he's just...
He's also claimed to be the leader of the Fishheads.
Political. Well, that's... I don't know what that means.
The Fishheads?
No, I do know the Fishheads. They're the gang that runs this place. We're the people. She like pulls off some stuff and like pushes up her arm, and there's just these like burns across my arm. It's like we're trying to stop the work that's happening in the factories and on the island.
Oh, you're a political movement.
Yeah.
Like a labor thing.
Yeah.
Oh.
Girls like fishermen stuff.
Hmm.
So maybe there's some connection there.
Sounds like this person is the head of many groups.
I guess so. I don't know.
So what was your purpose in coming here?
Take the this device, it's so they could.
Right, to make the.
To reprogram.
Right.
Or the, re-tinker the Tinker Soldier.
To kill people? Is this a terrorist attack? Oh, excuse me, is this a struggle of the people that involves killing many other people?
Yeah. It's really bad.
Hope it's his
people are dying out there. And they're mistreating us. Mr. Adderpool is a monster.
How so?
He's trying to control everything. We barely get wages. We couldn't even do anything on this day. He told everyone to go into their houses and celebrate the wedding. We don't have any food. We're starving out there.
Insight check.
Okay.
Let them eat whales.
Save the whales!
One.
I love killing whales.
One place
we eat you.
I don't think we do.
Just wait until you guys become the food for the whales instead of the whales becoming the food for you. It'll be awful. Yeah, they have 13 stomachs.
They have 13 stomachs. And this supplies
she does seem to be telling
the
truth.
Okay. Of their body.
The ratio of stomachs they need to kill.
Maybe like obviously hurt.
1 to 13.
Right.
Like what
maybe 2 to 13. Yeah. I'm not
Listen,
sure.
Young lady.
All I mean.
If the only thing you're doing is punishing evil with more evil, it's going to be exactly like Mr. Butcher did to you. You'll just lose thumbs.
You'll be dead by the third.
And then everyone will be thumbless, and no one can open doors anymore.
No one can open doors.
Can open doors with evil.
They can't.
Not well.
That
well, what if it's
sense.
One of those one that goes, you know? What are you going to do?
Bombs.
Just like Walmart. She just, that's true. But what if people are already cutting off our thumbs.
Well, then defend yourself, but don't, like, kill them.
We're trying to.
You're trying to.
We're trying to lobby. We're trying to send messages out. No one's listening. He's not letting us.
Well, you came to the right place. I mostly don't listen to this labor rabble, but it sounds like a great injustice is being thrust upon you all on this veritable, glorious island of. What's it called again? It's. Tulin, right?
Tulin.
Yes, of course. Well, there's a buffet here. You want some food to take back to your family or something?
I made it myself.
No, thanks.
Okay, well.
We're all dead anyway. She just, like, goes over on her side. I'm just going to take a little nap.
Well, I might have to be sure of that. Sorry. And I'm going to just. Hit her on the head with my pommel. So
wait,
to knock her out.
That's like
the
second
darts,
concussion within like 15
darts.
Minutes.
Oh, okay, that's much better.
That's like the second thing.
He's going to pick one up and minutes. Just try to throw it at her.
I guess that works.
Yeah.
Just, even if not, she just catches and just stabs herself. It's like, fine. She goes,
these are useful. I'm going to take all the sleep darts.
Okay. She maybe has like 9 now.
Okay.
All right. Yeah. Anything you guys do?
I'm going to pick up her thumb and put it in my pocket.
Okay.
Why do you collect such grim memorabilia?
As you pick up this thumb and just kind of as like you pick it up and you put it away, you kind of like take away and you look at like the blood that's in your hand, and you suddenly remember, you don't know why, but you remember last night a dream you had where you were chased by a headless chicken.
A giant headless chicken?
A giant headless chicken.
A giant headless chicken. He's like playing with it. He puts it in his pocket.
I'm gonna add a chaos for playing with it.
Yes, that sounds appropriate.
Okay, going over to you real quick. So, this will be kind of last thing. So, they're up in the little loft. There's more book areas and stuff like that. They just seat him down in a chair, and they're all around him, and they're like, "Okay, Granny's just like." And she kind of like steps, it's like she's kind of blocking you a little bit so they don't see. And they're like, lady. Like, all right, listen, this doesn't have to get ugly. But we just want to know something about. She pushes it down. You're not going to yell, are you? She lowers it. If you want money, we don't want money. I want to talk about purchases that you have made and given. Sorry, don't really do that sort of thing. Bit of
You're
clientele.
You're a shop owner.
Yes.
You make purchases all the time.
Yes. The lady just looks over. What? You. Granny, like, what the heck? Oh, it's fine, dear. It's not fine. Take care of her.
It's okay. We're old friends. We're old friends. It's great.
She's into sea things.
Yes.
Oh, goodness, Granny. Just because we're into sea things doesn't mean everyone who is on our side.
Hey, Percy. No, it's nice to meet
fine.
You.
She's great. It's awesome. She saw the Mariner. What?
Yes.
Is this true? She's going to roll the sea. If you're lying.
I'm not, as a matter of fact.
But you have to convince her. So you will roll to convince, or she shall.
Well, listen, I mean, actually, you know what? It'd probably be better if she just did it. I'm bad at convincing.
Who? Grand?
No, whoever's making the inside check should just make the
inside
check.
I'll just say, if they do badly, though, then they're not going to believe. So you can roll kind of a counter to make sure they get it. It won't be against you.
I'm going to start, like, rambling about the vision the other night and, like, seeing a guy in a diver suit and, like, the
face. She just kind of grabs you and just looks at your face, like...
Hello, yes, you're very close now. This is kind of in my personal space. I was telling Adrian about that earlier.
Working,
no,
she, like, lets go. This is you, and, like, Hattie's like, yeah, she seems to be pretty honest. Why did she... What did he tell you?
Who is this talking to me right now?
Lady. Lyra. She has the little thing.
To take care and have a nice life.
She looks over at Addie. Addie's looking at you. Addie's gonna roll to see if you were lying or not. And she gets really up in your face, but in a much more kind of...
Wait, who is Addie?
Oh, sorry.
We met earlier. It's the same
Oh,
way we
Andy
talked.
Is Addie.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, I know that sorry. She has different nicknames. I just want to
again,
confirm.
Again, personal space.
All right.
Yeah, so, like Adrian.
So what did you get in your role?
That's actually, I think, 2 successes.
Okay. Oh no, hard to read her.
Yes.
Gran, it's fine. The water talked to me, and I'm pretty sure sounds like a Mariner thing. I mean, you know, bringing people together. But dear, you do need to know if he did tell you something. Let's just put it this way. The Mariner is not one who just shows up and says stuff.
See, it's a little bit awkward.
Listen. We're all women here. We all know. We plug his ears. We all know what it's like. And the
not
struggles.
That kind of awkward.
Okay, good. All right. But dear, let me put it this way. I have been here for a long, long time. There is nothing under the sun that would surprise me.
So, is the Mariner like your god or something? Should we just do whatever he tells us to?
the lady's just like nods, but you kind of get like maybe a little hesitation there. Addie's like kind of shrugs. Grand's like
messages.
Like kind of just like does like kind of sometimes.
How do you tell?
Evaluate what he says sometimes.
It seems a little random actually.
Okay. Well, I would say that, you know, use your own judgment.
God, what the void. But I'm going to grab the amethyst right out of Lady Lyra's
Whoa,
hair.
What the heck? Her hair just, like, falls down. And she's like, whoa, what?
I did it.
What are you
What's
talking
going to
about?
Happen
My
now?
Husband
I got
gave me that.
This.
Give it back to me.
No.
Give it back to me.
The Meredith told me
Do you know who I am?
Yes.
I can rub
You're
your name.
You're very pretentious.
I can ruin your name if I want.
My name... It's really not that great to begin with.
What is your name, strange girl?
Ooh, ooh.
Pull a hand.
Perseverance Glemming.
Yes! Glemming. Yes! She's like...
Got him. They'll never figure it out now.
Okay, Joseph. Rampant use of aliases. I would advise you that if you do not want your name of Glemming to be ruined forever, why are you laughing? This I am
a little bit comical. I was telling my friend Butcher. I'm not sure if you've ever met Pusher. I was telling him about Bluster the other day and how eventually when you start threatening somebody, it becomes redundant to Bluster and then you kind of lose
credit. Grand girl, pull your
knives out on her. Pull her hands.
Sorry, dear.
I thought we were friends.
We are friends. I'm just pulling out my knives.
You're not going to stab me with them, are you?
She's head of our coven. I kind of have to do it.
I do that with my friends all the time.
Grand girl! No! Addie's like, okay, listen, we're getting a little hothead here. Let's just calm down.
I'm just gonna like
slow my weapons.
AJ, I should have.
What?
Yes. Not trying to beat him, but like.
Yeah, it's getting late. I'm sorry. We'll finish this up. Okay. What did he tell you? Because maybe that's helpful. We're trying to do something.
What do you
think he's trying to
do?
Blade just looks at. You're asking for about a specific bone charm that you sold. Didn't really sell those. People just took them and didn't know. I'm talking about a red bone charm. The kind of see-through, special. Doesn't exactly ring a bell. Addy, he's lying. All right, so you do know about it. Who did you sell it to? Client confidentiality. You're going to tell us who sold it to you.
It's probably not the best time to be hedging about morals. Trust me, doll.
Why is that?
Well, just because these women all seem very tense and stabby.
True.
And basic self-preservation instincts usually incline us to give people who are tense and stabby what they want.
Hard to explain, but I run by honor and not survival. Don't think it would be right. So if I die, that's okay. But I will warn you, there's a lot of people who really like me. So
you would love Adrian.
You will probably die if you do that.
Well, I don't want to kill you. I just is very stabby
yes,
lady.
I kind of assumed you don't seem to be a part of this.
Not really, no.
Yes, why is she here? She knows my boyfriend. It's fine. Gran, why do they have you here? Because I'm the only one who knows the ways of the sea craft.
You have to tell me about it sometime. Probably of a more void being.
Sure, yeah. That sounds good.
Now, what are you going to do if he doesn't tell you?
Grand, can you, send him to the marina or just, probe his mind or something?
That's something you could do.
Yeah, probably not. She pulls out, a old book. I'll look.
So she just peek over her shoulder.
She's just kind of, she doesn't lean over, but she's just going through it. You don't know what it is. It's a bunch of, I guess Akadeva writings and just normal writings and stuff like that. Mm. You don't know what's going on.
I look very intelligent as I nod.
The lady just needs a... All right, listen. You.
Joseph Ference.
I'm just going to walk back and pretend this did not happen. We did not harm this gentleman.
Well, I'm invested now,
only...
I'm invested.
Listen. Either...
This man is my friend's friend.
Either you're going to tell us what he told you so that we can know.
I thought you already knew that.
No. We don't know what he told you.
Why would I have taken your amethyst if he hadn't told me to?
What are you talking about? He didn't say anything about an amethyst or ruining my hair.
He did to me. Well, not your hair.
What specifically
did he say? It was already a bit ratty anyway.
What specifically did he say?
He said, find the amethyst.
Did he
Which I have now done.
Say it weirdly. You roll. Actually, you would know this. You think back and you're like, wait a second. Amethyst. It was amethyst. but it had a weird inflection. I don't think I actually did in the recording, but you know, it's like, yeah, it was kind of weird.
Yes, he was very strange.
Like kind of high at some ends and then lower.
He did this weird thing. What
the
normal thing like Amethyst.
Amethyst.
I'm gonna like tuck this into my hair.
That is mine, and that would be Steve.
Yes, but he told me to, so it's okay.
We've got permission.
No. He told you to find me. And
the
what
boss.
Else did he say?
Jacob, what else did he say?
And then bring him to me.
Oh. And then bring you to him.
Okay. Don't think he already visited me. I think he would have talked about that. When did you have this dream?
Like yesterday.
Okay, I had mine a few months ago, so I don't think that's what he meant.
Well, he said find the amethyst and bring him to me. So unless
okay.
It's this.
I am not a man. I need to bring
him. Yes,
to
but you just
I guess
said he was the amethyst,
him.
And I figured he must have been a little confused.
So he said, what, so? Go
find
the
amethyst and bring him to me.
Okay, I think now in the language of
how
the common,
yet?
Sometimes and means a continuation and sometimes it means a separate meaning. I think this is a separate meaning. This is a he told us to find him and find some sort of shard of blood that he has, a red bone charm it seems like.
That doesn't really sound like what he was telling me.
Perseverance is stubborn.
You see, I don't have time for this. This is important.
Are you on a deadline?
This is very stressful, so you could say yes. We have just kidnapped a man.
Yes.
You know, I'm okay if you just let me go. I won't say anything. Like, I will eventually, but like, after the party's over, I'm not a party pooper.
Very decent of you.
Just tell us what you did. Where's the rest? No. Fine. Okay, I guess we'll just leave. Girls, I guess take him. We'll try and leave before the lights come back on. That is probably all we can really do for session. Sorry for running late. I think they all just, well then, I guess we'll just sit here until something happens. And they all just kind of want to sit down. Or unless Grand finds something. And so they just kind of sit down. And you're not leaving us, okay? You're a part of this somehow. So you get to stay. But you don't say anything about us.
You've changed
or he will
line.
Find you. And what does the marina do? Grand. Sink you to the bottom of the sea and crush your bones.
Well, the first half of that sounds great because
it's
that's where we're
Jones.
And with that, we're going to just end session. Thank you so much. Sorry for going late. You can
All good.
All right. I am really sorry about late. But-